I ask you a question? Why you don't never play with my nipples? I got nipples too. It's my turn to get tied up. Not them handcuffs though. I got PTSD.
Welcome to Heart is Soft, where men speak, so hopefully somebody will understand.
When I went to go get my cut, I'm like, yo, listen, yo, where's Johnny?
Where's Johnny?
Right? I'm like, where's Johnny at? Oh, he's not here, papi. He come back later. I'm gonna have to speak Spanish because I hear this motherfucker with the wild thick accent. So I'm getting upset. I don't want to hear you speak English, right? So I speak to him in Spanish. I'm like, I bet. I'm gonna go get something to eat. I go, motherfucker's just sitting there chilling, eating. Yo, and I called him.
Oh, he
I set up the appointment.
He I set up the appointment.
I was like, you goofy fuck.
Wait, Bella, we good? That's bad for you. You know what got me tight about my barber? The nigga was cutting, right? I was up next. The nigga told me hold on so he can go eat.
Like, nah, yeah, that's
cool. Nah, but the wild shit is my barber would put the drape on me
and then dip
and then go eat.
No, that's why
he locked you in. Yeah. He locked you in. Wait, he don't go nowhere.
He prepped you. That.
Yeah.
This nigga prepped you and left you.
Me. Got me set.
Yo. Got you horny to dip.
Nigga
said your ball
you just sat.
Yeah, I just sat.
You let it marinate.
Nigga, you heard a blue balls. You got a blue fade.
You know what I mean?
But I got a question. Why do you have two brushes?
I got a hard and I got a soft. You know what I'm saying? I stay on brand, bro. 100 strokes to the left. 100 strokes to the right. You heard?
So your hair is horny? That's what you're telling me.
Yeah, I'm horny.
His hair is horny. Yeah, his liquor horny.
Horny. I'm throwing.
Oh,
I wasn't
gonna say nothing, but like, why would you choose today to debut Horny Juice with two new niggas here?
Bro, horny is a lifestyle.
But it's niggas here.
You know what I'm saying? That's just horny is a lifestyle. I don't give a fuck about these niggas. It's the play parties. They don't be niggas in the play parties.
And your
fivesome. Was there another nigga in the fivesome?
Y'all don't remember. Was it? Yeah.
You had your eyes closed.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I had to think.
You had your eyes closed?
Just now. I was thinking.
You ain't know?
I'm so confused by that statement. Like,
yeah, we have five sims. We do play.
No, rock out. It's your world. But my whole thing was, how do you not remember there was a nigga in the room? Like,
no, it was a nigga on the bed with him.
Oh shit! Like you're not keeping tally. You're not looking over like high five,
like
strokes.
I ain't like yo, good game, coach. You know what I'm saying?
But yo, the form would be better if you straighten out your back.
Yo, bro, straighten it up.
Yeah. You ain't hitting it right, yo.
I ain't going front though. A minute ago, I was in a barber shop, and I seen this girl like get this fade, son.
It was more fighting your fade.
Oh my god.
Waves is better than waves.
Yeah. But yo, the cut was so sexy, son. And then I was like, God, am I bugging? And then I just realized, you know, when you get like an epiphany, you start to notice shit. So then I realized, I had to be like maybe 16 at the time, but now I'm real, I got a thing for shortcuts.
Mm.
And I thought I was bugging, you know what I'm saying? Then I had this shorty at the time. Pussy was always tough. Pussy was fire, right? But then she got like a short haircut, and like the pussy got better. And I'm just like, yo, you ever felt like certain cuts made you more attracted to a girl? Like, damn, like whenever I get a girl with a short cut, son, it's always some unbelievable, mesmerizing type of fucking bun, son.
So my question is, like, when you hitting the doggy, are you like just
grabbing,
like whipping the back of the dome and shit?
Nah.
Like,
I'm a real
like,
waver.
I need a skin fade. You know, so
I'm a real
really
waver.
Really
so I'm like,
you
brushing her hair while you?
Nah, I just got it.
I got a hard and sore for you, my whole life.
You feel me? You just gotta let that shit marinate. You gotta get the side.
You gotta try that one.
Yo, but nah, sir. Yo, whenever a chick got a short haircut, yo, my antennas just go the fuck up. Like that's like my like if you not that cute and you got a short haircut, you're gonna be semi cute.
That's how I feel.
So
about
what you telling me is there's gonna be a lot of shorties in the chat just sitting there with mad baldies just coming out of nowhere.
But you don't like pulling hair though.
Yeah.
It's cool.
I like pigtails, son. When they got the toots.
The Harley Davidson joints?
Got them like reins and what's not. Like, that's
Undertaker.
With that fire. Yeah. Like a horse and carriage. Yeah. Let's go, shorty.
They're going to Harley. What's the style that a shorty could get that automatically turn you on right
I'm not even going to fuck with the style. Missionary and grabbing about her hair and pulling her head up.
God damn, bro, what the fuck?
So she kind of looking at you, but her shit is like, yeah, I'm into that. I think I'm starting.
But you want to push her hairline up? Like, I want to yank
the base of her hair.
What are you shifting gears?
What
hairstyle is that?
It's like I'm going to third.
I don't care. It's fucked up, but by the time I'm done, it don't matter.
Don't matter.
You don't care what hairstyle it is?
Nah. By the time we done, the hair is fucked up. I got to pay for new hair.
I like ponytails. I'm a big ponytail dude.
Ponytails?
Yeah, ponytails my shit. Because I know either we fucking, you cleaning, or you cooking.
Oh, you sucking dick.
Yeah, there goes.
Yo. There's something about wrapping the ponytail like a wet towel when she necking you, son. Oh my, like a Twizzler. Oh
babe, my bro, god, it's something man. About when they lean back on the bed, they give a head, then they lean back and do this shit.
Oh, yo, ooh, son.
That's the shit,
bro. It's over.
It's like when a nigga pull his pants, you know he about to swing. When she rap away, I'm like, oh, she about to swing on this dick. She
I start smiling instantly. I start smiling instantly.
She getting into her warrior mode. Like this is some serious shit. I fuck with that.
I ain't gonna front. A chick, wait, you don't see this that often, but a chick, dude. Jesus Christ, you on these tracks. Yo, bro, what
son,
the
y'all
fuck?
Seen these before?
Wait, what is that?
My nigga, who you fighting?
Wait, God. What is that?
This nigga over here Wolverine and shit. Yeah. Like, what are we doing right now? We need to become an X-Men, Pop.
Are those brass knuckles?
That's not brass knuckles.
He's just like claws.
Yeah, I told you what we're using
that. What are you using that for?
Not yet for you.
So
you gotta break it out.
I've Professor been like, X called him.
So you know I've been doing the tie up things, the BDSM shit. Yeah. Right. So I did the shorty came over, I put it in the leg restraints, tied it up and all that. But I saw realizing I only had like one trick in my bag. Mm. It's the same trick. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, damn, what else can I do to fuck shorties up? Like I'm covering their eyes, I'm massaging, I'm doing all that, right? Vibrators and all that, but I want to do other shit.
Like I don't want to like take you off shit, but my ADHD is fucking with me how shiny it's those just, are. Yeah. I can't focus.
My nigga,
chill. Rub this on your own skin.
You can't just you can't just bring.
I'm not gonna rub you.
Rub this on your own skin.
That's
bro, the you cannot statement just, too. You can't just whip that shit out like that though, bro. Like
it's fire.
I don't know. I'm assuming it's better when it's like sensual
shit, right? Even you doing that made me like, son, it's the it's some ticklish shit. Or
don't touch
like
me
that.
You scared? Don't touch me with that.
Yeah, bro, you scared?
Bro, I don't know what you've done with
what
these
contraptions. What different types of sensation play would you use on a chick? This is sensation play. It's like tickling.
So it's so, like so wouldn't it be like a feather? Or,
that's another one. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
The wheel is fire. You know, I like the
this
wheel.
This is like that. The wheel this is fire. This is almost the same thing, but it's just bigger. Pause.
The wheel. I get it.
You good?
I get it. I'm straight.
What, you use sensation play?
Nah, I never did that before, but I feel like that's close to like a shorty scratching my back.
Yeah.
That's close to that. Yeah. I like that.
What if a chick pulled this out on you?
That wouldn't fuck you up? I like when she scratched my back, so I take it.
A chick could rub this. I'll probably be scared. I ain't gonna hold you.
Nah, I'll let her do it.
I'm saying, are you bound or not bound?
That's different.
I don't really
bound.
I've never been, nobody's ever tied me up before.
Yes, are you?
When? Oh, at the party. At the party. But I'm talking about intimately. Okay. Intimately. Well, right? At the play party, I was tied up and they
helped. Pause. Let's dive in on this, right? So, so the question is would you feel comfortable enough to allow yourself to be given that power? So being able to be restrained by someone else and even maybe a sensory deficient, meaning like you get your eyes blindfolded, anything like that? Or do you start to feel like, for me, I like if you close my eye, like you do some shit like this and it's in front of me, I'm cool. You put it behind my back, I start catching PTSD, you block off my eyesight, I'm gonna start screaming. You know what I mean? Like I'm a panic. I'm like, nah, I don't like this. This is not, nah. Fuck a safe word, pineapples, whatever we gotta do.
That's my safe word. Yeah. It's seven.
Pineapples?
Seven.
Or seven. Pineapples.
Depends on who's
remember
a chick.
Remember that?
Seven.
Seven.
I ain't gonna lie. I feel you. Seven. It might be too overwhelming for me. I want to try it though, but I don't know if I can actually get too comfortable.
You just gotta hop off the cliff and just do it, bro. You gotta stop.
Nah, that's not. That's not. Stop
thinking about
situation,
it.
Bro.
I feel like a certain shorty will bring that out of you, probably.
Yeah, the Virgin Mary.
I'm with trying it. I just don't know.
Let's get this bro out of the way.
Virgin Mary. Nigga, you should, all the shit you done did, it gotta be somebody from the safe hate. It gotta be some real crazy ass type of sexual bond you have with somebody to really bring that shit out of you.
Real what, shit. Tie you up?
For him, I'm saying.
Oh, for him, yeah.
Everybody got different shit. Like, you know, a certain, like, that's a hard don't for him. Everybody got hard don'ts. For somebody to make you consider doing your don't, yo. Yeah.
Nah, I don't really got no hard don'ts. It's just I don't envision myself being tied up, mask on me, and actually being able to like enjoy it sensually.
So
I don't really see it being like, I'll do it, but it's kind of like, okay, wait till I get out of this. You know what I mean? It's not.
She said you did it at the party though.
Yeah.
So we'll make it different. Like the party.
There was 13 girls on me.
So you would do it with 13, but you wouldn't do it with one?
For 13, I would almost do anything.
It's funny. I hear 13, and I'm like, yeah, that sounds great. I would be immediately sensory overload. I wouldn't even know what to do. Like, this shit would fry. You just see mad heat coming off Poppy head and shit, and it would be a wrap.
That's a real thing. Like, when I go to the first Saturdays at the museum, the Brooklyn Museum,
yeah, I've been there.
It'd be so much shit, just be me the whole party.
Mm-hmm.
It's too much.
Yo, I'm like, what the fuck, bro? Like, I was like, yo, fuck all these bad bitches. I'm going to the bathroom. Real shit. It's
yo,
that many.
Is really your safe haven.
Yes.
How do you find out?
Fuck with that.
I'll be in there taking paper towel out for no ass reason. Just mad bad bitches. Mad bad bitches outside. I'm
just
chilling.
I just get disrespectful when I'm around too many bad chicks.
Why?
I'm trying to talk to all of them. It'd be a chick I just talked to right there, and I'm trying to talk to somebody else.
Drunk you or
and
sober?
While I'm talking
you?
To her, I'll be looking at her like.
Drunk you or sober you?
I don't know.
It's not like he out here fishing with dynamite. He's like, yo, is this the room? Is the grenade? Yeah, I'm catching you all. Let's go.
I'm a bugger.
Yo, speaking of drunk, right? Yo, you ever feel like, so you know, drunk sex in general, that's a thing. Mm-hmm. I was thinking about it the other day. I feel like drunk sex got like genres. Like, so like, Henny Dick, that's like drill music. It's Chief keeping them niggas.
I'm following you.
He really
wine,
following you. I'm following
you. Wow. Wine is like a Drake track. I'm bugging. Yeah, no, do you feel like there's a difference?
What's Sade?
Or some Sade. You ever Sade
definitely one.
You think like your performance be different based on what you drink?
Hell yeah.
So describe Henny Dick, y'all. Pause.
I feel like Henny Dick is like, I'm just pounding her.
Give me a song.
Dun, 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 dun. What's that one?
What?
Y'all gonna make me
yo, wow.
You know what?
What?
Come on.
He started barking.
Definitely
DMX.
What Henny Dick you look like, Ty?
Huh?
What Henny Dick you look like?
It's very aggressive. Yeah. It's a long night. It's a long, long, long night.
I don't know. Henny don't. I feel like Henny Dick ain't what the dick I be wanting to give.
Nah, yeah, because I ain't gonna lie. A lot of Henny Dick, I don't be finishing.
You don't finish? Thing.
You can't connect to your
plate. Yeah, I just be just pounding.
Because most dark liquors, depending on who you are, like cognacs for me, I'm wild aggressive with everybody. Yeah. So I don't like drinking it. Right, so I'm not in the zone to be like, I'm gonna get this nut. It's more like, nah, you taking this beating. I'm like, yeah, but that's not the bag you want to be
fighting.
In. Yeah, you're fighting. Essentially, it's a fight. Like my dick and your twat are having a battle, right? Yeah. And I'm gonna win this bitch. Right? It's like that. I'm taking this W.
Do chicks get Henny Coochie?
Yo, that's a good. They have to. I mean, chicks off Henny.
What would it look like though? Like
yo, it don't look safe, my nigga.
Like she riding. I'm gonna
keep it a buck. Whenever I fucked a chick off of Henny, every chick that I ever fucked off Henny twat was a chick I didn't want to have sex with that night.
Nah, that's when they start choking you, right?
Yo, that's when they start.
I ain't gonna lie, that's when I found out I like that shit. That's when I found out I like that shit. I was like,
yo, Henny twat usually come with, yo, I called you didn't answer. I'm like, oh shit, I already know what type of night this about.
Yeah, Henny pussy is like a chick, she on top of you and she starts squeezing. She never did that before.
Never.
And she starts choking you and squeezing your neck. And you better not give my dick to nobody else. And you looking at her like,
you know I'm giving it to somebody else.
I just met you tonight.
This plan for this shit's gonna be given away tomorrow.
Why are you doing this?
But so what about wine, y'all? Off the wine.
Wine is on some making love time.
Fact. Yeah.
Slow and sensual.
Yeah. Passionate. Show me a good time. Oh yeah.
Yeah. Drake. Yeah. Yeah, definitely rubbing you up a lot. Kissing a lot. A
lot
yeah.
of foreplay.
Yeah. A lot of foreplay.
I like wine me.
I love wine me.
I be feeling me too though.
Nah, shit, tequila me is bugged out.
Tequila,
what's the difference between tequila and Henny then?
Tequila's tough.
I feel like I'm more fun off tequila.
I was about to say that.
You're more experimental fun. With tequila.
I'm licking, I'm eating more pussy. I'm eating ass is crazy. The way I'm eating the ass is crazy.
This nigga said finger licking. Yeah. I fuck with the energy guy.
Yeah, I'm definitely, tequila is a more fun, hard drunk. You know what I'm saying? But I'm definitely exploring more. I'm doing more fun shit. Henny is very aggressive dick.
Yeah.
Super aggressive dick. It's almost
I'm
not
talking
safe.
Wild too. Yeah, it's almost not wild shit coming out my mouth.
It's not cool.
I'm definitely spitting on you violate. Like wild shit. Yes.
I might violate because you be too drunk. It's too aggressive. So I might do some shit that I probably should have asked consent for.
Yo, that sound like an ass to mouth night for you, bro. You good? Just like
my ass to her mouth?
Sure, fuck it. It's your world. He says, the world floats your
boat. Get in there. God damn it. Open your mouth. Get in there. Yeah.
I ain't going front.
Exactly.
Henny will probably have me do some shit I probably will regret the next morning. I ain't going front.
You going nut in it?
I've definitely not pulled out off some Henny dick before. Like, off. Plan B. Like, almost. It's almost like a 65% chance plan B.
I ain't plan B. I probably plan B off the wine, though.
Why?
Because he pulling out in general is what he trying to say right now. He low key was like, yo, we could have had wine coolers. I'm still not pulling out.
Like, give me a glass of water, bitch. I'm still in there. What are you talking about? Right, where the Gatorade?
Yeah. Nah, I just feel like with the wine is like super emotional, super passionate. Mm-hmm. It's like, yeah.
You know why I like the wine? I like the wine because I feel like I be in control of my performance. It's like I feel like I'm a little enhanced, but like I still like I'm feeling it. You know what I'm saying? Like I feel like I'm here. Like I might fucking just wave or some shit out. Fuck it. I'm feeling it with wine. But I ain't gonna front. Henny puss and keep that. I'm good.
This is
what
I told you. I want you to try shrooms though.
Now, I had shroom sex before.
He's been pitching that on me for a minute.
We are the only niggas in the world where I haven't done shrooms yet, bro.
Like,
yo, come on, don't start this shit.
Please explain, yo. You against something you don't even understand.
So that's cool.
It's like
bro.
You racist. It's almost racism.
I am.
Well, you never tried shrooms.
You don't fuck with Mario? Shrooms? You see what I did there?
But Mario did like weed and liquor only.
I don't really drink or smoke.
Oh shit!
Like so the only like, lick I would like do what was the is wine.
Sex, shroom sex was amazing. Like you could feel everything, bro. Like
with the condom on or off.
Yo, go ahead, fuck with it. Man. Talk
that condom. What? I mean, what's that? Oh
my god! Condom was off in this scenario, but like it's just like all my senses was heightened. I felt like I don't know how to explain it, but
it's literally the exact same shit you be saying all the time.
That's how you know the truth.
It's almost like y'all spoke to each other in the bathroom. Yo, when you come out, you just
he's
say
like,
this.
Yo, when I go out there, yo, talk come about out, shrooms. Say nigga, shrooms. Bro,
when I was on shrooms, when I had the threesome, the story that we told.
I have a threesome.
We all took the shrooms. We're in here for 3 days. Mm-hmm. The day we took the shrooms, I literally was eating pussy for like 5 hours, bro. Damn. And I needed it.
I need it.
You know sound like some human centipede shit. Yo, like they're all in a line.
One of them is giving me head. The other one's laying next to me. She's rubbing. I'm like, yo, please climb on my face, please. She's like, no, I don't like riding feet. I'm like, please, I need it.
So shrooms had you moving.
I'm begging for it. And then I'm in there and I'm like,
what do I do?
No, I'm in there. Like, I'm literally in her hole. Like, I wanted to be in her pussy with my face.
That's crazy. That's crazy, bro.
That's crazy. And later on, she was like, I never really liked tongue inside before, but you was fucking my shit up. Like, I was starving for pussy because of the shrooms. It's like you so focused on whatever, like, the senses is crazy. Yep. I was going nuts, bro. I was eating pussy. I was going from one pussy eating one. To eat another one. I just needed to eat box.
So you would say your best sex. Shroom sex is the best sex to you?
Ever.
The best sex I've ever had was shroom sex.
Both of y'all. The best sexual experience you ever had with shroom easily. Sex.
It's not even close. Because your senses is nuts. So just imagine your dick having more power, more feeling. Imagine you wanting to be in sex like more. Like, bro, I was willing to do whatever for these bitches. Still not doing
shrooms, but I hear you.
Sneaking one to that
like
over
9,000. Yeah, you feel me? It's like, over 9,000.
If y'all want to hear the story, go onto our Patreon and go to that best was weekend. Was it best weekend ever?
Yes.
Best weekend ever. Bro, I tell a story about three days, bro. Just understand that we was in here for 3 days going nuts.
So you had shrooms every day?
Nah, we was drinking every day, bro. Okay. We was making drinks and shrooms and... Whew, I'm sweating, bro. Just think about
it. Nah, you caught the flashback.
Nigga, relax. Right?
So, I've seen chicks catch flashbacks. You ever be on the phone with a chick and she's like, whew. Yeah. Nigga, that shit just happened to me for real.
I got a question for y'all too, right? So shroom sex is the best sex you ever had. What were you like immediately after the shroom sex?
That's a really good question.
That's definitely a good question. I gotta think about it.
What does that mean? Like, in what way?
Like, how were you? Like,
what was the aftermath?
Describe what you felt like, what you looked like. Like, how were you?
It's like, what's that word when you just like, you first of all, surreal. You can't even believe this. You cannot believe this just happened. So it's a word for it though, that something je, something like where you're just like it's bliss, bro.
Like, I'm about to say bliss. Like how it was for me, It felt like it was a little spiritual, a little bit.
Nigga, what?
Oh, spiritual my God. Pussy. I'm telling you.
I feel like it was a little spiritual. I feel like it wasn't only physical.
Where she at now?
I'm still with her.
Can't leave. I had shroom sex with a chick in 19.
No,
I'm just playing.
Oh, my damn.
Oh, my God.
Nah, at least 6-7 years ago, I can still go. That we are connected in that way through this, through that, that those moments.
So she got a permit spin the block card.
Absolutely.
Permit spin the block card?
I think, but you know, we ain't fucking each other while I was in a relationship, but I knew when she was in one, she knew when I was in one, and we still communicate from time to time, but we don't even like each other on some other levels, but through the sex, we on some other shit.
So you know what's funny? I sit down and I think about it. I speak to my mans and all that shit like that. I feel like whenever niggas get some really good box, we kind of always all do the same shit. Just lay the fuck out. And knock the fuck out. Like I kind of sound like you, minus the shrooms. You know what I'm saying? But it's mad funny though, because like when I sit down and I think about like my best dick performances, like you think about your greatest dick performances. Mm. Now, I don't know about y'all, it could just be me. But whenever I give a chick some really good dick, she be mad energetic after. Like you ever gave a chick Yeah, like she be mad productive now. Like now she want to clean the crib, cook and shit. Yo, that shit happens all the time for me.
I know, so like, I call them Hall of Fame fucking performances, right? Yo, like in your mind,
Hall of Fame is like she sleep.
Yeah, that's what I would think
on the floor.
That's what I would think.
Hall of Fame performances. Hall of Fame performances are subjective. They're subjective. There's no objective Hall of Fame.
We're talking
like for instance. I know Lou's talking about himself. I'm talking about me. Like when I'm like, you know what? Whether she enjoyed it or not. I killed it. I did me.
That's not Hall of Fame, bro.
I did some shit I didn't even know I could do.
You put up 40.
Right? You know what I mean? Like, yo, I had the core strength I didn't even know I had, bro.
I feel like that's a good game. Hall of Fame, you got to be inducted into the Hall of Fame.
Ooh. I'll concede what I previously said.
That was a good game you had. You got to be inducted into the Hall of Fame.
They got to say it.
Yeah, word,
They got to say it.
Yeah, word. You got to, they got to pick you. Yeah. They gotta all pick right. you.
I fuck with them.
They gotta.
I was
pick
pulling
you.
A LeBron. I'm the GOAT type shit. You know what I mean, like I felt it.
What made you think if you was having Hall of Fame? What made you think this is Hall of Fame? What was the thing that was like, yeah, I did it?
We'll put your game sliders up.
So wait, what it is like there's certain things that automatically hit, right? That's a good idea. Movement is huge, right? So like if Shorty's getting into it, you can feel like her gyrate with you, right? Because if you're just beating up her shit and she's staying still, she's a fuck doll. There's no difference between her just, you know what I'm saying, you just jerking your dick and you sticking your dick in her, right? But if she's gyrating, she's into it, right? The other thing is there's certain things that happen, right? Like cream on your dick. She's really into it if there's cream on your dick, right?
She's just a creamer.
That a
or
vino?
She could be a creamer.
She just might be a creamer.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I mean, but you put some on your elbows, make sure you're good. You just take some, you be like this. You know what I mean? I'm not asking. Yeah, 100%. I'm Puerto Rican. I love eating pussy. Everything pussy related.
I ain't going for up, bro. I was going to say that. I ain't going to be racist. Nah, nah, boy, nah, you nah, already nah. got like, you already up five.
Yo, I'm like, wait, I'm so already
on your own. So you like,
and then
I fingered, and then there have been cream on my finger. I lick it right off. No issues.
I ain't there yet.
How long you been eating pussy, bro? You Spanish. Be honest.
Son, since I was like 12, 13, bro. As soon as they was letting me get up in between them shits.
Oh my God. So you have been.
My man said it's not a milkshake, Pop. That's not how this works.
It looked like what?
Yo, you are really ahead of the fucking times, bro.
I was out here all the time, but that was like an automatic thing.
I see what you did right there. I see what you did. What made you think that it was Hall of Fame dick that you gave Shorty?
So it's kind of like how I felt, but if she sleep, and I'm feeling like
Brock Lesnar.
Like I feel like this. Then I feel like I did a Hall of Fame. And then if she bring it up, like when she wake up, or we fuck again when she wake up, that's definitely Hall of Fame for me.
Think so.
Shorty kicked me out the hotel.
Why would she kick you out the hotel if it was Hall of Fame?
I don't get that.
I'm beaten. She squirted twice and she never squirted before. The second time she squirted, she like crawled back on the bed and was like feeling her body, and she was just like,
oh, she got the tremors.
Yeah, she was like, nah. And you gotta then go. I'm standing there like, you know what I'm saying? What we doing? And she like, honestly, I think I just need to be like by myself right now. Like, and she like kicked me out the hotel.
What?
She was just like,
I'd be walking to my Uber. Like, how long
ago? I'm walking back to the car. Like, so I said, like, yo.
Shit.
And never
straight hand, no brush type shit
again?
Yeah.
Word.
That yeah, counts Hall of Fame, though.
She, nah, me, that's tough.
To me, it was.
Yeah,
to me,
like, the shit was like, so lit, she kicked you out.
But she ain't come back, though.
He's too much. It's too much.
Sometimes shit be too good, bro.
She told me that, literally. Like, yo, nah, you on some other shit. I never, I can't.
I'm going to keep it a buck. Certain pussy, I don't want no parts of. Like, there's certain chicks I knew. It's certain, like, this going to sound crazy. Like, there's certain box that I had, and I think my who's attached to. I'm like, yo, your shit's so strong and I'm so weak. It just, I'm not going to fight this battle. Like, I'm not doing it.
I appreciate you sitting here being honest about that. That's a certain level of being comfortable in your skin to say that. Because honestly, it's been times where I've did that shit too, where I was just like, not only the person, but the pussy was too much. Shorty was wild.
I've avoided pussy before.
Yo, sometimes pussy dumb you out, bro. God.
I want a shorty break up with me. Like, yo, you... Yo, it's too much pussy. I can't. I like you, but I don't got enough dick for me for you. It's too much pussy. It's you got too much pussy. It's a lot of pussy. Her ass was fat. She's beautiful. She was knocking my shit back. And after a while, I'm just like, yo, I don't have no more dick.
Insufficient dick is a real thing. That is a real thing.
I don't, bro.
Insufficient dick. Like, be like, yo, listen, you declined here. We got no more. That's it, mommy. That's it. I can't help you.
Like, man, I've died. Like, it's really done. You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes, like, I'm going to keep it a buck. Like, you really, as you get old, like, you know, when you young, like, ain't no pussy that. No, there is.
Nah, there is.
There is pussy that I have no desire to swim in. I don't want no parts of it. Keep Jaws away from me. I don't want to know what's in there. Leave me alone.
You fucking chick too good?
Yeah.
What did she do? How do you know you fucked her too good? Like, you know what?
Depends on the shorty.
I was going to, you know when you fucked the chick good, you have to compare how she act prior to you fucking, mm-hmm. how she act after you fucking.
Facts.
Like, when you fuck a shorty real good, now the good morning text start rolling in. Mm. Like, oh shit, now I get a good morning with a purple heart emoji? Oh, really?
Purple heart emoji. Now that you was a hero in the war.
Because she know that we at war.
If shorty never talked about ever making you a meal and all of a sudden she show up at your job the next day with a plate for you, you did too much. God.
You don't even know her last name.
You don't know shit about her. I don't know your favorite color. Mm-hmm. I don't even remember the color of your eyes. Man, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, and she show up and she was like, I made you a play, daddy. Or hit you with Poppy or daddy off rip.
See, you only get that because you fucking Puerto Rican. They don't be calling me Poppy. I wish bitches called me Poppy.
I love when she calls me Poppy.
Thank you.
Yo, y'all gotta start calling me Poppy.
I love it.
You gotta stop fucking shit. Spanish bitches.
Love it. Absolutely.
Either that or just be like, yo, we going to an island and be like, you gotta prep for it. How do you prep for it? You start with Poppy.
I knew, yo. That's it.
We're going on vacation. You got to start with Poppy.
I knew I fucked this chick really fire because she started watching Dragon Ball Z after. Now she's sending me mad Goku memes and shit like that. I'm like, damn. Right. Anime is tough.
Let's do it. First of all, what have you ever fucked? Me and him, I'm a lion. I'm glad we on the same couch, me and him. Y'all can stay here.
It's all right. It's cool.
Damn, y'all stay over there. It's crazy, you feel me? Right? That's a lot. All right, fuck y'all. I'm with it.
It's the shroom, like, yo,
you know what? I did too much.
I did too much? Like during sex?
Yeah.
Nah. I feel like I got a good radar for how much I should give.
You do?
Yeah.
So you got sexual awareness? No, I've never heard a nigga say that before.
Why are you so inquisitory about it?
Because, I've never heard a nigga say, yeah, I know exactly what dick to give shorties at what stage. Like, we usually just go all out from day one. Like, I never heard a nigga say,
I wouldn't regret it, though.
You said what?
I wouldn't regret it, then.
Why would you regret it?
No, I wouldn't regret it.
You wouldn't?
Like, I wouldn't.
Yeah, you see. Oh, okay.
Hold on. So you go off rip 10 every time?
Not any hell no.
No, yeah, because I don't give playoff dick every time. I don't.
Every time.
Nah, I don't give playoff dick. Nah, we not.
I realize it's a mistake.
It's definitely a mistake. You cause yourself mad problems. Let me start saying, playoff dick off rip.
I just stopped doing that. I just stopped doing it like a couple months ago though. So let me not even say him.
So how many months clean?
Carry the one. Might be like at two.
I remember one time I had a shorty. We had been beating for a while. We was cool. I was on her dick. Mm-hmm. I was super on her dick. But one night I had a playoff night. I had an 81-point night.
Mm-hmm.
And I knocked it down. I'm on the edge of the bed. I remember knocking it down. I'm on the edge of the bed. And like, she came so hard, I just like dropped it.
You dropped her?
And she like fell asleep on the floor at the bottom of the bed. I got in the bed and started watching TV.
But why did you drop her?
Bro, she's at the bottom of the bed asleep. On the floor.
But she fell.
On the floor, yeah. She like was like
dead body.
Gone. Her body was just shaking and all that. She just went on the
You
floor.
Didn't think you to check on her?
This nigga's not checking pulses. He's like, you ain't checking. She's pulse. Good. I'm gonna watch TV real quick.
She turned into a completely different woman.
When she woke up.
No.
That you liked?
Weeks after. She, it was like very intense. And I think I told the story. Like, nigga, she literally drove to my crib. I was staying with my homeboy. The door was locked. She went around the back, climbed the fence, came in through the back door.
In Atlanta, this one using an A? I remember the story.
Nah, Pop, that ain't
it. I woke up, nigga. She's over the head of my bed. Like, Tahoe, are you awake? Bitch, first of all, you know I'm asleep.
You see me sleep.
You see me sleep. You feel you me? And so I had to look around like, yo, how'd you get up? How'd you get in here? She said, I climbed the fence. You climbed the fence?
Like, damn, are you athletic? I like that.
I may have go back out, climb back over the fence and go home. But then I realized it was from that night. Because she changed from that night.
So you never killed again, though?
Yeah, I did.
I ain't going front. Sometimes, nigga, as a nigga, you get what you ask for. Like, you ever, like, unlock something you shouldn't have unlocked in a shorty? That really do happen.
What is the things that make you give, like, what is it? All right, so let's say solution-based combo, right? Mm-hmm. It's men out here that's listening right now. And let's women go. Out here. Mm-hmm. What are things that put you in a Hall of Fame, joint sex? Like, what are the things that, like, a man could do, like, yeah? Give some tips.
So, you see... So for me, I used to honestly look at sex like objectively till I started coming on this podcast. So it's like, yo, you got.
That's on Patreon only.
I ain't gonna lie, no.
I've never seen that.
I stopped because I had to pause myself. So I stopped mid combo because I did have a pause.
I've never seen him come on this podcast. Okay.
So.
never seen him.
Do it in the bathroom.
Yeah, exactly.
But nah, so like I used to look at it. I used to look at it from like an objective standpoint. Yo, she got a nut, or she got a squirt, or this, that, and a third. And if I didn't get that, I would look at it like as a failure.
Uh-huh.
But in reality, sex more so be about the route than the destination.
Explain.
You know what I'm saying? So it's pretty much like the foreplay. You getting her started. You know, you paying attention. You know, you learning new things. You getting her. You getting her ready. You learn her. Imagine if you could like. So me personally, I could learn a chick. Like 5 minutes. Like 5 minutes. If I'm really like, cause I don't just start eating pussy like swimming right away. Like this is more like let me get my feet wet. So I'm in. Okay, I'm in here.
Did you just make a eating pussy noise?
He did. 100%. You know
like look, just I'm in here.
I'm just trying to make sure we're all on the same page.
So I'm very familiar with those noises. I know.
You feel me? You know what I'm saying? So like I'm like okay, I'm licking here. She do this. I'm licking. I do that. Finger. She do this. No finger. She do that. Like I'm paying attention to everything off rip. You know what I'm saying? This is before I really get started. I'm getting started. I'm doing body play. I'm like oh she like it's like some chicks like you rub their stomach. Oh you going crazy for the stomach? Go up to the nipples. Oh it's crazy. And this is all before I even think about putting my dick in. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm putting my dick in, it's the same shit. Like, what kind of strokes you like? You like the head? You like the whole shaft? Should I go balls deep? So for me, the reason why I feel like I always get the Hall of Fame right off the bat is because I'm fake looking at
you
my opponent.
Win every game?
I ain't gonna hold you, bro. I'm nice. Like I'm dead nice. I ain't gonna front. You know that? You know that?
Like yo, it's and one ball. You know
that
all day?
You know that nigga in the park that's dead ass nice? Like I'm dead nice. You feel me? But yeah, like he said, no ref. You feel me? But yeah, the reason like why I don't really go in thinking I'm gonna just get a performance. I want more. I'd rather you have a Hall of Fame experience than me have a Hall of Fame performance. And that's why I always gonna have a Hall of Fame performance every time. It ain't really about me. Because what the fuck is that really about if it's just me?
Right, you been talking about your dick for 5 minutes. Can we get a guest some time?
You know what?
All right, so now we're gonna move on to my dick, I guess, right? So. Which dick we going for this time? Pause. Right? No.
You can purchase dick on Amazon.com/coming first.
Use code Ambiance for 10% off.
Yeah, so a lot of what you said is kind of like, that's the vibe. I think that just comes with age, though.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
As you get older, like, at first, all you're thinking about is just pounding it out. Yeah. You're going through the motions. Like, you have your game plan. Like, I know, like, when I was younger, I had my game plan. Yeah. All right, how am I going to do this? And it was like I was playing Madden and shit. Like, I had my playbook, and this is the playbook I'm running. And that's how I'm getting my touchdown. Plan. Exactly. Yeah, you don't figure audible. That out until you get older, right? Mm-hmm. Because, again, you're setting yourself with what you would believe are tangible goals. Yeah. Did she nut? Did she squirt? Did she scream? Did she say daddy? Did she say my name, how she said my name. Like, you're setting these tangible goals in your head to think that that's going to be what's going to get her off or where you can call it a dub, right? But as you get older, you start to realize for you, it's not even that way, right? Because a bitch can make you come and you didn't enjoy it. It's just what my body did.
Whack cum, whack nut.
Whack nut, right?
Yo, whack nut.
So it's the same thing. So you start to sit here and empathy builds and you start to have an understanding of what the other person feels and what they want. And you start to look for it. You look for the signs. You start, all right, well, she starts to grind because I'm hitting her G spot with my fingers. All right, well, now I'm going to lick her clit. Let me make sure I pull the hood back a little bit. Let me give it a little suck. Right, you know what I mean? Right, and then you start, right?
You feel me? Got a little hot. I'm familiar with your game.
Right? Keep talking, nigga.
where the horny juice?
Yo. Oh shit! But like, these are the things that you start to do when you start to catch the feels back, and that's exactly how I've done it. Like, as I've gotten older, that's been my playbook, is going to what my reactions are more so than what I thought that I needed to do off rip. But then also, then that goes into, does the other person kind of reciprocate that same style? Because if they don't, then maybe they were just interested in getting the nut, and it wasn't nothing other than that. Like, I want shorty to fuck me the way I'm fucking her. Mm-hmm. I want to put in that same energy. Because that's just going to really turn it up. Like, if you're doing the same shit I'm doing and we're both looking for cues and we're having a good time, it's a long fuck, one. Mm-hmm. And two, by the end of it, no matter what happened, we both enjoyed ourselves.
Yeah, for sure.
Facts.
For sure.
Fuck, but that's that. Even on like some one-night stand shit?
Yeah, nah, one-night stands, I'm probably showing out. I kind of, like, not like I'm like fucking sitting here over the fucking body with the arms flexed, but like, I want to be able to sit there and be like, all right, bang, that's another one that I understand. I got her feel, I got her vibe. And then when she sits there and chats about it or whatever, it's cool. But I'm not giving like off-rip playoff dick. Like, I'm not going in there with fucking the headband on and the jersey and I'm just sitting here trying to clip her shit. Mm-hmm. But I definitely want to make sure that I'm putting in that work that I know is going to get me a positive reaction.
You know, Tahoe said something that was mad important. I was sitting here thinking about it the whole time. I'm like, yo, I never thought about it like this, but it's really a thing. Yo, describe what a whack nut is to y'all. Because I've had a
set. Nah, but that be on your body, though.
It's hard to do sometimes. It be you. Whack nuts really be you. Facts.
Nah.
No. You ever like,
disagree.
You ever been like being your dick and had a whack nut?
Yes.
It's you.
No.
It's you.
What you were using to get you to where you were. Because again, if you're beating it, it's not like you're fucking sitting here and setting yourself up. Did I like the candles? Let me get the lotion. I really like the scent of. No, you're trying to get a nut. You're just beating your dick. Foreplay. Right? There's no, like, no, you're not foreplay. You're not like, you know how I like my balls grabbed. And you're talking to your hand. You're not doing that, right? So, like, of course, some of those nuts are going to be whack. But if a woman is there, and this is a person who's supposed to be doing some of the same things we're doing for her, then at that point, that whack nut is because of the experience you're having with that person. That's it. Because
so it's day four.
100%.
You know why I can't say that? Because I feel like as a woman, before you could you can't expect a nigga to give you that orgasm if you can't orgasm yourself. So I can't really expect for you to come out here and do shit for me that I can't do for me. So like, I know like, yo, nigga, before I go to work, I'm gonna get a big one off. You feel me? I might be a little late, but I'm coming there relaxed.
I hate when you call me in the morning now. Don't even.
I just finished.
That's because of that.
But the morning time be the. That's why I can't. This nigga acting funny because the horny juice and y'all niggas is around. You feel me? But I ain't going front though. So like.
Don't do that.
I ain't going.
He's shooting.
Somebody's shit getting fucked.
I ain't going front. Like, I know when I'm about to get a horny. It be me. You feel like, I feel like a nut is like a fucking slingshot. Like that shit, my nuts come from my fucking feet, my nigga. I ain't gonna lie. I feel that shit come from my bunions, straight up my fucking calves, up my thighs. Sometimes that shit miss my dick and go up here and then come back and it be some shit like nitro. Like I know when I'm about to have a good one. Sometimes I feel like I be fake rushing my shit. I get those little.
But again, that has everything to do with, there was nothing preset. You're making the exact point I just made. You're like, all right, I got to go to work. I might be a few minutes late, but I got to rush this one out. Are you sitting here putting the time into your dick? No. You're rushing your dick.
I put time into my shit.
Right?
Like, or you be lighting the candles?
I like where he's going with that.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it, you're rushing your shit. You're not sitting there like, all right, cool. Let me make sure everything's good.
For me, it's more like whack nut comes with sex when I want to last longer.
Mm-hmm.
And for whatever reason, my body just shoots it out. And yes, I'm like trying to stop it or whatever.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
That shit is just like, oh, I'm not. Oh,
yeah.
Yo, sir, I hate that shit, man.
You know, like, you don't know, you never been in that situation?
Hell yeah.
You know, if I move, it's over.
Yeah.
And you don't move and it's still over?
It's just good.
So now my question there is like, what?
Nah, that's some real shit.
That's
bro.
Really what it is.
I try to hold it down.
I was thinking, like, cause it's not her. Like, I know it's me. Like, I know. Like, nah, I put myself to this point. It's my responsibility. I should have maneuvered.
Where
differently.
Where does the whack nuts start from?
Where does it start from?
Mm-hmm. Shit,
yo,
I would say it starts from here.
My whack nuts always come from when I'm trying to. It either comes from when I'm trying to force or when I'm trying to last too long, like you said. Because when I'm trying to last too long, now I'm not on my regular gameplay.
I think I'm focused too much on my pleasure, not enough on hers. innately, like I, like inside somewhere, mm-hmm. I'm feeling like I'm trying to do too much, mm-hmm. and for some reason it start feeling good, and you don't pay attention because you got to know when to chill out.
Yo, you have to, you gotta have sexual responsibility, bro.
Your body's telling you this is feeling too good.
Relax.
And that's when your shit is. But you're like, oh yeah, this does feel like, oh, I'm doing my thing. Oh yeah, this is good. This is good. So, oh shit, I'm about to, oh fuck.
So yo. y'all don't feel the tingle first? Like, yeah, I got the tingle in my sack, and I'm like, and I pull out and I start biting and shit. I'm like, because immediately, I'm not nutting.
What are you biting?
I'm biting hard.
I thought about it for a second.
Wait, how am I gonna pull out my own dick and bite it? Ah, pay attention to me. Listen, like what the fuck?
We've seen that happen on this podcast. That's all I'm saying.
Niggas on this podcast do suck their own dick.
That's what I'm saying. That's wild.
Yeah, we've seen.
Poppy don't have that maneuverability. So what? Like, if that's the case, I'm a pull out. I'm a bite. I'm gonna play with the pussy. I'm gonna say something dirty. I'm gonna make it something else. And in the back of my mind, I'm running through stats. I'm running through the most foolish shit in my mind. How many calves can a zebra have? Yeah. Like the most dumbest shit to get my mind off that nut, and then I go back to it.
Where does it start? That means it starts in the mind.
Oh no, 100%. Well, like the issue comes from you being so involved in it, where it is
you're not paying attention
to one, her pleasure, and two, the instinctual thing of get the nut, because that voice never stops. No matter how much you think you got shit on lock, that let me get the nut, it's always in the back of the head. Right,
your nut.
Yeah.
You see, the voice in my head is talking about her nut.
With squirrels.
Nah, nigga, that's always it. The same way, like, you're always programmed to be like, you see pussy and you be like, if it was available, I'd fuck it. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, your brain never stops that. That's the instinctual part. Like, we block it out because, you know what I mean, we have some sense. Some of us. you know what I mean? But for the most part, that's what it is. I've been trying, bro. It's been working. I'm doing good.
So, you see, the thing with me, sex for me, the minute I get in some decent box, I know, like, yo, if I do 3 minutes of specific stroking, I could be out of here.
Facts.
So I know I could take myself out the game real quick. You feel me? So the voice in my head is, nigga, you know you good. Like, I know I'm going to get buckets, but let me make sure that I could get her shit cool. Let me get her rocks off. I ain't going to front. If I don't get a certain response or reaction, I'm going to feel like I ain't really do what I was supposed to do.
That's why I knew he was never going to get a ring. He was always worried about scoring. He never brought other people into the game.
Facts.
You take other people.
He came about scoring and winning.
Then winning.
Yeah,
so
facts.
It's like he's going to get his off.
And that's it.
The rest of the team is sitting there looking at him.
Again.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
That's really facts.
That's how niggas be when it comes to pussy.
But don't have Carmelo
back to the analogy. Melo is going to be in the Hall of Fame, though.
Yeah, but, I mean, that's cool.
Who's putting him in there? A bunch of other niggas.
Yo, you killed Kim, bro. You in the Hall of Fame. I saw her walk after you was there. Yeah,
real shit. Yeah.
Of the niggas. Like,
real
you
shit.
All right, you in the Hall of Fame.
Real shit,
man. You know what I'm saying? But the bitches. Yeah. Like,
nah, I feel what you're saying, though.
So, you know what I mean? So, you know, here on this podcast, man, we like to, I ain't gonna, we joke about sex, talk about the cliches and the taboos. We try to be sex positive as much as we possibly can for the, you know, just to put that good energy into the atmosphere. So we sitting with two grown men, right? So I'm assuming you guys have been familiar with pussy for a long ass time.
Yeah.
How do you look at sex now? How is the way you view sex now different from how you did from maybe when you first started in the game?
Shit.
That's big.
Damn, so that was a long time
ago.
That's
a huge difference, though.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, you rock on this first.
Walk me through that.
Like, even like...
And not just sex, even women.
Nah, yeah, like back in the days, it was a numbers game. Like, stats. How much? Now it's more like a quality over quantity thing. Facts. For me. Before, I just wanted, how many bodies you got? Word? All right. How many you got, bro? All right, boom. Now it's more like, I'd rather it be... Good. Yeah. Then for it to be,
I ain't gonna front. That might sound nasty, but he ain't say not one lie, son. I used to be in my niggas like, how much you got for the year? 12? I bet. Like, I ain't gonna front. That's really a thing.
I'm still young then.
Well, you still
nah.
I don't know, but I like pleasure. I like giving women pleasure, and I don't know. I just think I'm talented at it, and I just like spreading pleasure. I know that sounds like a whore.
This nigga over here, the globetrotter of dick. You hear him? He was like, dude,
sex his voice
good up, dude.
It's not all about dick. Like I said, I had an experience recently where I didn't need to have sex. It was just literally just taking her to the top. And I enjoyed it that much that by the end, I was like, no, just chill. You good. Don't worry about it.
You're a giver.
You see?
Yeah.
I enjoyed that. And I don't know.
But
don't
the
know.
Difference between what you're saying and what he's saying, you're more so saying, like, you want to spread love because it's the Brooklyn way, but it's more so of, like...
Even when he was younger, though? Like
nah, hell no.
Definitely that's why he said what's the difference between
So for you, you just want to spread that positive experience. Yeah. With us, it was we didn't give a fuck what the experience was. Yo, I got one today. Yeah. I got three yesterday. I don't give a fuck if it was two strokes. Yeah, you get what I'm saying?
I might hit 11 this week.
You ever been in a party and you counting Deli or how many dubs you got? Like, that's how we was looking how many numbers you got? Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
I think the big issue for like when I was younger was you always had the same circles, so it was always the same shorties you were smashing. So you were running through all the same bitches. Like, everyone fucked, you know what I'm saying, this bitch, that bitch. Like, everyone smashed it. So, like, you're whatever on her list, but you hyped to have her. Meanwhile, you her body. Mm-hmm. Like, she definitely got more bodies than you do. And it's you and all your niggas that she got, right? So, like, when I thought about it, when I thought about it like that, right? Like, and now I'm my focus now is essentially who do I want to be around after the nut? That's my main focus, right? And before, back in the day, was I didn't give a fuck who I was nutting with. I just wanted the nut. Mm-hmm. Now I'm more focused on after the nut. So what are we doing after the nut?
I agree.
You don't want to, do I even want you laying next to me after I let this off?
I agree.
Right? So I don't even bother if I can't answer that question.
Back.
I don't even see a point in it. Damn. I have wild kids. I'm old as shit at this point. I say that, but I'm not that old. I'm old though, right? So like, so I like, you know what I'm saying? I've already lived a large portion of my life to where I don't want to sit there and be like, oh, I got this nut. Ah, right,
so I got a question.
You know what I mean?
So you've never been like sexually attracted to a girl that you're not really into?
Like, every day.
That's all the time.
So then that kind of
come with it. He said he's not gonna go.
No, I'm not going with it. Yeah, right, because right. If I can't sit here, like when I'm done, and be like, I want to get the rag for you, and then maybe we can lay down and talk, or maybe go out and get something to eat, or if you want to sleep,
I want to get the rag for you.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to do something for you. Because if not, then bitch, you want to do it yourself. Because I'm done at that point. Poppy's clocked out. He's like, no, mommy, I'm not working. Like, I'm done. It's over. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But if I want to do something for you, it's because I genuinely appreciate you being there. It doesn't necessarily mean that I want a wife shorty or anything like that. It might just be a vibe. That person might be a vibe. I like to talk to them, whatever. It has to be something more than just I wanted to get my nut. Because that seems shallow to me now as I've gotten older.
I will admit, if I can just interject real quick, I agree with him on that too. I'd really do that for people that I like. Mm. I'm not just out here just... You know what I'm saying? But yeah. If I like you, I want to put you through that. I want to give time and sex and, you know, pleasure.
Mm-hmm.
But it's based on the fact that I like you. I don't know if I can really do it if I don't really enjoy sex. You like that. Like, you it's kind of, if I don't even think that I want to have sex with somebody if I don't have, like, it's people that I've been physically attracted to, but because we're not
sexually aligned.
Yeah. It don't got to be sexually. Way, it just got to be like, in general.
I don't even know if I could be really have, enjoy the pussy. If we're not aligned in another way where I actually feel you like that, like, mm-hmm. So you could be pretty or sexy all you want, but if I'm not feeling you,
mm-hmm. There's gotta be some form of depth. It can't be that shallow shit. You know, I saw that. I got you. How many kids does Poppy got? Poppy got 5 and a grandson.
You have a grandson?
What a grandson?
God damn, you late, nigga. You Spanish. You should have had this shit like fucking 10 years ago, nigga.
I mean,
God damn.
I mean,
fuck with you.
I could have tried harder.
I'm gonna be honest though. Me and Tyler had a conversation that changed my life forever, and it wasn't even like a conversation that was meant to have like that. We was talking. I forgot what we were talking. We were talking about something. I'm gonna phrase it how we phrase it. So don't kill us. We was talking about bitches. And we was like, yeah, you know.
Could you just say women?
Nah. I'm going to give it to you. I want to tell a story bitches. So they can see exactly how it went. Talking about bitches, right? And I forgot what we were talking about, but it was something about, like, niggas having mad bitches. And we was like, yeah, you know, niggas do be having mad bitches. But do they be bad, though?
Mm.
And when we say bad, we don't just mean, like, just looks. It's, like, the quality of the woman. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you bad, but can I talk to you? Are you funny? Can I hang out with you? Do I want to go out with you? Do I want you around after the nut? Do I actually look forward to maybe going out with you and not having no sex involved? Like, it got to be a bad situation. You know what I'm saying? So I ain't going to front. So when I go to the club now, well, you know, I be in the spot. The way I even look at women now be different based off that conversation. It's like, okay, you cute, but you like a headache. I do say that shit in my head. So I'm just like, I don't think it's going to be a bad situation. You know what I'm saying? Or, you know, damn, your energy kind of fire. What's up? Now I'm really in the club looking and I'm scoping out for different shit. So I feel like as a nigga, now that I'm of the way, like to answer the question that I asked y'all, the way I look at sex, well, sex and women now, my definition of what's attractive, totally different, son. Because I ain't going to lie, bro. I done had mad bad bitches on the surface, but I didn't really have too many bad bitches on the inside.
Wanting to fuck somebody because of the way they think?
Fire, son.
Son, what? I was on the phone with Shorty the other day, right? So, boom, two different situations. I was talking to one girl, and I said, you fire. And she kind of blew it off. But I think she blew it off because I think she think I said it because she looked good.
Yeah.
You fire because of the way your ambition and the way you carry yourself and get in the car and you go open the door for me or you push the door open. Like, that's a lot of extra energy. OD. And I'm just like looking at Shorty like, yo.
Who sent you?
Yeah, like, that's wow. But then I'm speaking to somebody else. I know I'm a whore, whatever. I just got out of a relationship. I'm doing a lot. Fuck y'all.
Do you think?
But talking to somebody on the phone and we're having this intellectual conversation for about 20, 30 minutes. And I said, I'm not going to lie, the way you talk make me want to fuck you, bro. The way you think makes me want to fuck you, bro. And she got quiet, and she was like, that's really the best compliment I've gotten in a long time. And I was like, it is? And she was like, yeah, because you're really into the way I think. That shit did something to you on another level, the way I think fucked with you. That's a compliment. Most niggas just want to fuck you because of the way you look. And I was like, yeah, see, I'm a dope nigga. Because I didn't even realize that because my shit started like pulsating because of the things that she was saying. I'm like, yo, this bitch is fire.
But you got to be a different type of nigga to even be in that kind of stratosphere. I'm going to keep it a buck. I ain't really like a girl for the first time I left. I was like 24 years old. The first time where I actually liked somebody.
Nah, that's crazy, bro.
I'm being honest, bro. The first time that I actually liked a girl for her and not just how she looked or her box, I might have been damn near 24 years old, bro. Like, if I was speaking over the phone, I know what you look like, I still like you. The first time that ever happened, I was 24. You know how many chicks I done probably ran through and how many relationships that I probably done sabotaged, how many lives and hearts I done broken because I didn't really even know what the fuck who I was or what it was that I liked. So you got to be a different type of nigga to even get into that kind of globe. You feel me? Like, now I'm actually trying to fuck with chicks that I actually like instead of just sticking around because you got a fat ass. Stick around a little bit, but not as long as I used to. That's crazy. You know what I'm saying?
So now the question is the sex better than when you was just chasing the bodies?
Oh yeah, sex get better when you get older. I ain't gonna.
No, I'm just talking about with the vibe for the mental more so than just.
Like, oh yeah, I believe so. I feel because I ain't gonna lie, when you connect with somebody like on some mental shit, like y'all connect on some sexual shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like I remember one time I was having sex with a girl I like. I closed my eyes, I kissed, and next thing you know, we just interlocked with our fingers. Like, when the fuck did this happen? It just happened. Oh, you know what I'm saying?
About dude.
Chill out.
This nigga's R&B playlist was playing in his head all my body shit, right now.
I ain't going for. I'm afraid to fuck Erykah Badu. She one of them chicks. She one of them chicks who pussies I want to stay away from. I ain't gonna lie.
That's just not
I'm
you. Good.
No, I'll try it.
Her box. She remind me of shrooms. Like if shrooms was a person,
if pretty was a person,
if shrooms was a person, it'd be Erykah Badu.
I agree with you, and that's what made me want to try it.
You see, I'm afraid of drugs. I'm good, bro.
I don't think it's her pussy, though. It's I think it's not. The sexual experience. It's the
vibe, yeah.
Son.
So what, say...
She's going to have the incense like, burning. She's going to have...
She makes you a meal. Like, she makes your body a meal. So I feel like she does things that most other women... And I said this on social media the other day. I said, women have gotten to this thing where it's like, understand our struggle. Mm-hmm. Women have said that to men. Understand us. And so for the last 20 years, ever since Destiny Child came out with Say My Name,
yeah,
men have been under the thing of trying to understand women, like the we're scrutiny, because we're not understanding. But I don't think a lot of women in this day and age actually try to understand men.
Of course not.
So the time and effort, and I'm not speaking to the ones that do. Shout out to y'all. It might be a million dollars in y'all.
Yeah, please don't kill us.
But there's 7 billion people out here. There's a lot of women that don't put in that much effort. They feel like, suck his dick, make him something to eat, shut up. That's what I've heard to do to niggas, and that's it. But niggas is intricate too.
That's not like that's the wrong playbook.
That's the same shit we were talking about. They go through their playbook.
Erykah Badu does a lot. She might worship a nigga's body. Like, she might really take it there on a nigga and feed a nigga grapes.
You wouldn't want that? No, you wouldn't want that though?
Let me tell you why. You wouldn't want a bitch to worship your body? Let me tell you why I wouldn't fuck a chick like Erykah Badu, right? I don't want to fuck a chick like Erykah Badu Cause I'll be ass naked on her bed,
yeah,
laying on my stomach.
Her tongue in your ass.
She's gonna take her elbow and put that shit right here and know that this shit was hurting me without me saying a word. Any chick that
I want that.
She,
though.
Here's the thing. What are you talking about? I don't, because now I'm here every day. Now I'm making you chicken Alfredo, and now I'm shutting the fuck up. Now I'm running your playbook on you, bitch. Okay, we are gonna trade places.
I'm gonna eat pussy.
I don't want that. I don't want that. I want to keep my sanity, my nigga. You seen Andre 3000, nigga? Do I want to leave here looking like crazy. Andre 3000, nigga? That nigga been wearing Picasso hats and wife beaters. I don't want that, nigga. I want my Timbs, nigga. That's why I'm not fucking Erykah Badu. She walking around the Timbs. She gonna put a Tim on my head, nigga. And I'm gonna like it. I don't know what to say. I don't want to fuck no Erykah Badu.
Crazy?
The fuck is wrong with y'all niggas, man?
Y'all do. Yo, we. That's because we're not used to coming out of. She gets these niggas out of that toxic masculinity.
She
state.
Do.
The yeah. thought of having to do certain shit to exist. All of them niggas broke through that shit. Mm-hmm. She did whatever she did. She got them niggas out of that shit where they was wearing dashikis when before they was wearing, say, or Tim's or whatever.
Jerseys and shit. Yeah.
She was like, yo, you can exist as energy. And that's some shit that happens in the house, nigga. Yo. With all of that sage. And she started selling pussy incense.
Yo,
and
she sold pussy incense, my nigga. That's
and niggas,
fire.
I bought it. Shit out
you bought it?
Yeah. Like I said, I was first in line. So I pre-ordered.
It was pussy flavored candles.
How do you really have good? A house smelling like somebody else's pussy?
Like, well, again, smell like box.
Yo, what if your shorty that's come over like, yo, you was burning another bitch pussy? Like, yeah. Yeah. Like, how do you explain
it? Smell
that?
Like pussy.
Is that cheating?
That's Erykah Badu.
Is it cheating if I'm burning Erykah Badu pussy?
It
candles?
Is if you jerk off to it.
Sorry.
If you burn,
by the way, but if you jerk off to it, but you thinking about your shorty while smelling Erykah Badu's pussy inside,
that's a threesome.
That's a threesome. There we go. That's a threesome.
You ain't asked your bitch for consent. If she don't know that you got another bitch in the room.
Oh my God.
You violating.
Listen, welcome to Hard or Soft.
What's up? What's up? What's up?
Where men talk and we hope to be understood.
Yeah, let me get some more honey juice.
Yeah, facts.
That's so fucking crazy, son.
We are.
It's so fucking crazy.
Yo, the horny juice is crazy. I'm here with the one and only.
I'm good.
The outstanding, the comical, intelligent, best co-host in the world. Myself. No, I'm fucking with you. My brother, man, Tahoe TV. How you feeling today, man?
I'm on the horny juice. Y'all know what it is. Life is good. I got my Wolverine claws.
Yo,
know
bro.
What I'm saying?
Bro, please.
Life been lifing.
Please put that away, bro.
Why? I'm not going to use it on you, nigga.
There's guests here, man. Behave yourself. Man.
I guarantee you, anybody listening to this shit, so boom, right? When I want to, I'm thinking of doing different sensory shit.
Where'd you get that from?
Electrical play. I forgot I got the electric shit in here.
You have electrical what?
I seen a nigga take the electric wand, and it had an attachment that looked like a U. One went on the chick's butthole, and the other one went on in her box, and he turned that shit up. She said, da, 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 da. She said, ooh.
He tased her?
Nigga.
That's what
that
was.
Nigga.
You bought it?
That's a cattle prong, bro.
You bought it?
Wait. No, I got it. We got it here.
You bring it out.
Right now?
Might as well.
I don't know if we got it, and I don't know if it's accessible. Is it accessible? Melly be tucking shit away. So I don't know if it's accessible.
You got that from Nick?
I want to use that. I want to use... wax. I'm gonna shout out. We gotta do a roar with Hito. I want
yo,
Hito.
Yo, shout out to Hito, man.
Or maybe a sex exercises with Hito,
mm-hmm.
where he teaches us how to do wax.
Yo, his wax play is tough. And his shit be glowing in the dark and shit like that. Look like a fucking Busta Rhymes video.
But it's like putting it on is one thing, but then you could like prick it off.
So it's like hot though. It's hot wax.
It's hot wax and then it dries and then
you got this from Nick?
Prick it off, yeah.
You got all this from Nick?
Look, so that's the
shout outs to Nick at Erotic Boudoir.
Yeah.
All of this stuff could be purchased on her website, which is mindbodyandsoul.com. Is that it?
Touchingbodymindandsoul.com,
where she supplies all of our sexual essentials. And that looks kind of dangerous.
That looks like a fucking cattle prong, bro. Like if you're trying to like herd the cows, you know what I mean? Like, yo, it's time to milk them.
Yo, listen. If you guys are listening and you would like to see what's going on, please go to our YouTube. We have a new YouTube, as you guys may know. If you see any of the videos in the old YouTube, you will realize they're cut short because we're now putting our full episodes on our new YouTube. So the new YouTube link is in the description section of all of our videos on the original YouTube. So please be sure to come over to our new YouTube so you can see Tahoe play with this microphone looking contraption.
Oh, I'm trying to get the plug. I want to plug.
So while Tahoe does that.
So Tahoe's trying to, like, you dead ass trying to.
The Hard of Soft Show. Correct, Melly? The new YouTube channel? The Hard of Soft Show. So we are joined here with two young debonair brothers. Shout outs to the newest members of this podcast game. Now, I spoke to you guys. I was actually, it's so funny because I felt like I started seeing you guys on my newsfeed maybe a, dare I say, like 9 months ago.
That's right? Probably when we started.
So when you say you started like a year ago, I'm like, oh shit, I literally seen y'all from when y'all first started, man. So can we please introduce you guys, man? So who do we have here?
Well, yo, it's your boy Jay, aka Brooklyn Poppy.
But why'd you just say it's like a battle rapper?
Because sometimes you got to let niggas know what's up.
In case you got beef with the pussy.
Yo, yeah, just in case.
Yo, it's your boy Mel, a.k.a. Legendary Shit.
Legendary Shit.
That's a fire-ass name.
A.k.a. Legendary Shit.
Ambiance, Legendary Shit, Jay.
Brooklyn Poppy.
Brooklyn Poppy.
Brooklyn Poppy.
And Dick Flair.
Dick Flair.
Dick Flair.
Dick Flair goes wild, son.
Yeah.
And
that's woo! Nuts. And yeah.
And you guys are the Who Hurt You Bro podcast.
Who Hurt You Bro podcast.
Where the fuck did y'all get that name from? But I know what it means though. I get it. But what's the origin behind the name of your podcast?
I got it. So we worked together.
Okay.
And what wound up happening was we get into a lot of arguments. Like we are super argumentative, right? And me, I tend to play devil's advocate for no reason, just because I like to argue because I think it's funny. So I'll sit there and I'll argue, and then it always came down to like what we would say back to each other, be like, "Yo, this motherfucker's hurt. Look at him, he mad. He this, he that." And then when we decided to do a podcast, we were thinking of names and we were thinking about things that we said and what would fit, and just wound up being Who Hurt You Bro.
I fuck with that, cause Who Hurt You Bro is mad funny. Like if you like, I don't know, is that some Brooklyn shit? Like, yo, Who Hurt You Bro? Like, is that some Brooklyn shit?
That's some Brooklyn shit, and that's some common shit. Cause as soon as motherfuckers be acting up, that's the first question I ask. Like, who hurt you, bro?
I feel like that's a question women ask niggas when they be right. Like, who hurt you? Like,
oh, he's hurt.
Yeah, he's hurt. Look at him. He's hurt. Oh, my God, man. But, yo, shout-outs to y'all, man. But shout-outs to y'all. So, I'm hoping you guys would read the email, right?
Yes.
So, you all familiar with our game?
Yeah.
We have a hard or a soft. You guys got your hard or softs ready?
Well, I got my hard and soft somewhat ready.
Okay.
No, I'm not sure if you're ready.
I'm not ready, but I figured out.
So I'll give y'all some time. So before we go into that.
Hold on. Let me see. Hold on.
My nigga.
That looks fucking wild, son.
That looks like a fucking. Like you could cut hair with that. Wait, hold on. Let me get this for me.
Yeah, please. Because I'm not recording this. This is wild.
Hold on. See if you can see that.
Y'all ever went to the dentist and they cleaned your teeth?
The whitener.
Yeah.
The smaller head.
This thing got a pussy whitener.
Yo.
My nigga.
The pussy bleacher is out here. Me? This is crazy.
Niggas, what are you a fool?
Oh, yeah.
My nigga, that's the shit they put the mouthwash in, bro.
Boom, right? Let me see if we can.
Oh! Yo, this motherfucker is zapping himself.
What an ecstatic shock, my nigga.
You see it?
Yeah, I do see it a little bit. Nah, this nigga's a nut ass nigga. You are
Electro's
a
wilding out here.
You are mutant for real, nigga.
Started with the X-Men claws, now he got electricity. This
nigga Black
nuts.
Lightning is wild.
Now the shit dope because this shit come with a different contraption, right? This shit here. Now, if you put this shit on your body, as long as it's touching your skin, you could put it like in your pocket or something, or on your body somewhere, and connect this to the shit, the fucking shocks come through your hand, my nigga. So while you touch,
or if you touch somebody else,
oh, that's what Shorty did to me at the thing. Who did Cat? Did Cat do that?
Now,
why you? Is that what Cat did? Right?
Your touch
that should literally give you superpowers.
Yeah.
Your touch now becomes electric.
So you're a sexual mutant.
You could actually finger pop. Your dick becomes electric. All that.
Yo,
so you got electric dick out here, Pop? Yeah,
my nigga, if I'm eating some box and that shit electrocutes me, I want some more. I ain't gonna lie.
You understand what I'm saying?
Bring that Con Edison over
I'm
here.
Running away.
This nigga said bring the Con Edison.
Would y'all want electric head though?
Yeah, I want
nah,
that.
Nah, Con Edison pussy sound fire.
How does that feel?
Nigga, I'm about to find out. Nigga, you do shrooms, you being pussy?
Electric head sounds a little scary.
That's
to
tough,
me.
Man. That's tough.
But especially because there's water in there. That shit might amplify the motherfucker.
How did it feel when you put it on your hand, though?
It feels like electricity. It feels like a little shocking. It feels like a little shocking.
I actually did that before.
So the thing is more like when they tie it up, especially if you're going between 2-3 different types of sensory plays, mm-hmm. and then you include that or add that, it's like, I want to see what happens now with that. So that's going to be my next bag.
If I get my dick sucked and she electrocute me, nigga, I might take a screenshot of my body. Just, oh, shit. The fuck was that? Oh, my God, again.
But bitch. That's the thing, the difference between just fucking and experiences.
That's a fact. And I feel like the reason, one thing that I do realize, at least with, like, with us on this podcast, I feel like the main thing that I learned from this shit is, bro, you just want quality experiences. You know what I'm saying? Like, the stats is cool, but you just want quality experiences for real.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, that's what life's about, right? It's experiences. It's what we want to enjoy. So if it's going to be something that you're going to partake in, you might as well excel at it and enjoy it. And
but a lot of us, so they tell us about, and you know, shout out to y'all because y'all talk about shit like that too, mm-hmm. but they tell us about what we do for the community, and I really ain't get it until I realize how many niggas is taking gems from us and actually applying it to their sex lives or applying it to their lives and shit like that. Like, we're actually helping, even on a minuscule scale. Like, you know what I'm saying? We not the fucking CDC of fucking
but just sex. Showing that alone, people, somebody might go buy it, and now they household just a little more happier because they seen it on your show.
You understand what I'm saying?
We'll be sure to put the information for that in the bio.
If you notice how many women are in here, they paying attention to shit. Mm-hmm. We joke a lot today, right? We joke a lot. But a lot of times, they actually able to take gems and be like, yo, and ask their man, like, do you feel that way? Things that they would have never even thought to ask. They never even thought, because we're all programmed. We wake up, we eat, we go to work, we come home, we feed the kids, we go to sleep, we do the same shit the next day, and we hope for a fucking Sunday we ain't got to do shit. You know what I'm saying?
Work.
But there are questions in there that we're walking right past. And then we get comfortable with our partners. Long as he's all right, you're all right? I'm all right. All right. We're good. But there's other things in there that he could be way better. And that's kind of your job. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So the fact is that we really are helping the communities. And you know, I ask all of the people that come here, take that shit forward. Let's make this fucking world a dope-ass motherfucking place based on this shit, like create legacies. You know what I'm saying?
I fuck with
this power that we have. You understand what I'm saying? I think we're actually doing some shit out here.
It's pretty solid though. Like having the conversations around, like, because we do a ton of shit. Like, you guys do your shows, we do ours. We do street interviews. We ask random questions. We see tons of people. We fuck around, make jokes, have a good time. But then you start to hear some of the answers back for some of the things that you say, and you start to realize that people tend to kind of enclose themselves and set themselves on the same standard path and never want to deviate from it and kind of shelter themselves from really fucking dope experiences.
Everybody is. So we're saying, like you say, experiences. Most people just doing a 1-2.
That's
1-2 step.
1-2.
Yep.
Nobody's doing the cha-cha slide in their life. So it's too dangerous. Yeah. Nobody's doing that.
R.I.P.
Everybody's doing a 1-2 step because it's easier.
Yeah, he passed away. Yeah. R.I.P. I don't know his name, but.
I don't know. That's why I said R.I.P. to him. Okay. You know, and also, too, I'm going to be honest. You know, like, what I realized, too, from looking at this Discord. Yeah, whenever we'll be in the Discord or whenever people come up to me and they talk about this podcast, more than likely, it's a woman that approaches me. And you know why I really fuck with that? I really like the fact that here on this platform, men speak and women listen. Like, we usually say men speak, we hope somebody's listening. In my head, I'm like, I hope men speak and I hope women is listening. You want to know why?
I hope the men is listening.
That too. But for me personally, I want, because I like to be understood, I like to be comprehended, you know, and that's my bag. That's where I be at. You know, I be with women. So, like, the fact that women be taking the time out their day to write us, ask us questions, and ask us for feedback and get of our opinions and shit, like, y'all really care about, like, we got y'all to the point where you care with, like, what the opposite sex god is here, how we think. Yo, I fuck with that OD.
Nah, but women, to me, pardon me, y'all, I know we took y'all out.
No, Rob.
The ladies, they more freaky, they more willing to do shit. They like, they waiting for niggas. They kind of meet niggas at where they at, and they say, all right, this is what he's cool with. I'm not going to ask him too much more because, you know, men. It's the niggas that I want to listen to this shit and take that shit home, because women be open for all that shit, son. Women be open for all this shit, son.
That has a lot to do with the fact that niggas aren't comfortable saying that they have boundaries and that you're allowed to push up against those boundaries. Yeah. If they never say anything, they're not going to do nothing. Yo, you know what I'm saying? Atypical women. Yo, don't be touching me there. What you doing? Yep. Right? No. know what I'm saying? Like, you have grab to be his comfortable. Ass. Yo, that's first off, that's how you're going to know if he likes anything behind it, right? If he slaps your hand off, that might be a no-no. You know what
grab
I mean?
Grab his ass.
Like, yo, what are you doing? Fuck out of it, right? Yo. Like, I'm not one of those. I don't like anything back there. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'll deal with the gooch, but if you go too low, I tell everyone I'll give you the flick. It's a love flick, though. I'll be like, ah, you're too low. Stop it.
Right? Nigga, but, did you just flick on the forehead?
Fuck yeah. Right? Yeah. So, right? But there's other things that I'm super into. I like BDSM, I like tying up, you know what I'm saying, clamps. Mm-hmm. Like, we even said this shit on the pod. Like, I had nipple clamps on before.
My nigga!
Right?
He on the right couch. Right? On the right motherfucking
right?
couch.
I had them on. Welcome it wasn't really side. My thing, but I had to try it because I wanted to do it to someone else. So I had to be open enough to be like, yo, guy, you rock out. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I'll give you that power to rock out. And then I was like, come here. You know what I mean? So, you know, but that's the thing. Like, when I start having these conversations, and me and him have had them, we've seen people on the couches with us and talking about it. And then, like, they hear shit, and they immediately, like, they cringe up. And I'm like, it's really not that crazy. Mm-hmm. Like, we're not talking about nothing nuts. Mm-hmm. This shit way beyond what we're talking about.
You're not used to men talking about it.
That's Facts. What it is.
You're not used to men talking about it.
You saw that shit that I had sent you the other day with the shorty with Lil Baby?
Oh, yeah. Shorty told on
Lil Baby. Yeah, yeah, facts. You know, so long story short, I don't know how true it is or how not, whatever. But allegedly, a girl said that Lil Baby pay her 40 racks to, like, finger him in the ass and play with his butt type
oh,
shit.
Oh, shit.
And she said that show on an interview. She showed DMs, designer third, et cetera, et cetera. And I was so pissed. Like, I was like, damn, you know what I'm saying? Like, a nigga felt comfortable enough with you to do that. You know what I'm saying? The privacy. And now you're just going to blow the nigga up. But then I thought about it. Thought about a story. When I was a kid, there was this girl. She was a hoe. So what niggas did.
You said a prostitute.
No, she was just a hoe. You feel me? So,
I was trying to save her. But damn,
no. Little. So what the niggas do? They called her a hoe. Well, what did she do? She got sad. She cried down the third. Until one day niggas called her a hoe. And you know what she said? She said so. And then after that, calling her a hoe ain't work no more. Mm-hmm. You feel me? So I say that to say, like, I wish as niggas we could just own up to her. Like, yeah, I like that. Like, okay, now what? Like, what's the next step? Like, if you own that shit, can't nobody weaponize that shit against you, my nigga.
That's what happened to me on Twitter.
Just everything happens to you on Twitter.
No, that's crazy.
I literally said, yo, yeah, I like anal play. And they, oh, you like that? And I was like, yup, I do.
Yeah.
I'm not fucking you. Yeah. Why are you worried about it? Why are you talking about it? I like this shit.
You take all the power out of it once you own it. Mm-hmm. And you own it, it's over.
You know what I'm saying?
Right? Because at the end of the day, the only thing that's ever going to hurt you, what they're going to do, keep saying the same shit over again? Duh. And okay. What the fuck you talking about?
Like, that's a whack joke now.
Like, all
right. You know what I'm saying?
I'm still doing me. People still want to do it to me, so I don't see a problem with it.
Yo, the minute you own that shit, they can weaponize that shit.
But by the way, Shorty, for telling a little baby that was foul because he paid you $40,000.
That's fucked up. I want my money back, too.
I paid you $40,000. To not be messy, man. If that was the case, if I knew you was going to do all that, I could have took you to fucking dinner, gave you some liquor, whatever, talk your ear, act like I was going to be with you, fucked you, and never spoke to you again.
And she fucked the bag up. He probably would have called her again.
$40,000.
And now ain't no nigga coming your way now, man. It's over.
Yeah, because you chatty. Like, why you going to fuck up your money like that? That don't make no sense. And never mind you, why you ever going to shame somebody for doing something? Mm-hmm. Like, wouldn't it be crazy if he turned around and been like, yo, that's nuts that your pussy has a price? Wouldn't that be fucked up if he started blasting off like that? Like, yo, you know, we got bargain basement and she like mid-tier because that's higher end bitches than her. She trash. Like, there's a bunch of ways I could shit on her in a heartbeat. But it's still shaming for what? Yeah. First off, if you have the ability to do whatever you want and someone give you money for the time you decide to put into them, rock out. It's your world.
Bands. And my thing is, she did it. Like if she was
you did it. Like you did it.
Like if she was against it, like, oh nah, he wild, I ain't like then I understand that. You took the money and you did it. So you
was here.
Like you like I can't believe he likes his ass played with, but he sat right here. Yeah. Like, what the fuck?
So
like what are we talking about?
But anyway. So I ain't going front. Sometimes I be at work. And when the patients annoy me, I just go to the bathroom.
Nah.
I go to the bathroom.
Where were you about to go with this?
Just chill out.
And no, chill out.
Just chill out. Just chill out. I'm going somewhere. So I scroll the internet on my unauthorized bathroom breaks.
Yo, he's the bathroom guy.
I be at work.
That's a safe space.
Half my shift be in the bathroom. I ain't going to hold
you.
Flares in my job
a favorite store?
Yeah, I have a private bathroom that only I know the code for. Because the janitor gave it to me and don't nobody use it but me. It's not even on my floor. It's like on a whole different side of the building.
Fire.
So I was online.
Everybody knows you like the bathroom.
Can you relax?
Even the janitor.
Can you relax?
Even the janitor.
Tiana, that's
like,
funny.
That's my bathroom guy.
Tiana, that's funny.
I'm sorry.
How did Jennifer find that out? Enough to give you this code, say it's private. Yo, you could just use this one, bro. I know you'd be struggling.
That's great. That's nuts.
That's not nuts.
I'll be in the bathroom, bro. It's my thing. I'm owning it, so you can't weaponize it, bitch.
You got it, bro.
You was here. But anyway, so I ain't gonna front. I ain't gonna lie. I feel like we always hear these sexual facts and things like that. But I'll be like, yeah, I know that already. I want some facts that I didn't know was facts. So I went digging real deep. Pause.
I was waiting.
Eat that. Go ahead.
Pause again.
Eat that.
But I came across probably some of the most interesting sexual facts the world has ever seen. And I don't know if this one is true, but I know it's true for me. Maybe it's true for y'all. Did you know if you wanted a better chance at having an orgasm, leave your socks on? It says, forget lingerie. If you want to increase your chance of having an orgasm, keep your socks on during sex, says research done by the University of Groningen. No one is sure exactly why this works, but one theory is that in order to orgasm, you need to be totally relaxed and anxiety-free. And cold feet can interfere with the ability to really get into sex, especially for women, says Fran Walfish, PhD, psychotherapist and author.
I knew this and actually brought it up on the pod as a random fact that I knew. Because I read that same study. Because I was bored as shit. Not in the bathroom, but I was bored as shit, right? And I was reading through studies. I'm a big study guy, right? Depending on when I'm in my mood to like argue or whatever. In order to argue, you have to have the facts. So I needed the facts and randomly came across this dumb shit. And I'm like, socks? Orgasms? I like this title. And read through the whole fucking shit. And yeah, they sat there. I think it was like 105 couples. And they had them fuck without socks on, had them fuck with socks on. And every time with socks on, they achieved orgasm at almost a double the rate.
I will admit, the only reason I take my socks off during sex is because I be sliding when I be on my floor. If that wasn't the case.
They had the socks with the ridges on the bottom, grip joints.
The hospital socks.
What? You be sitting there and you just be getting, it's like you rocking Tim's, but you smashing and you mad light on your feet.
You feel me?
Something crazy.
Air Tim's is crazy.
Yo.
If I had a pair of Air Tim's, I would never show my feet.
So what is it about the socks? What is it? What is it? Preserves the heat?
Were saying that, so pretty much what they said here, they said that
it keeps the blood flowing.
It says the theory is you need to be totally relaxed and anxiety free, and cold feet can interfere with the ability to really get into it.
I agree with that. I think got some truth to that.
Yeah.
Have you ever been smashing and shorty touch you with her cold ass feet, kind of throw you off? I'm like, can you get these ice cubes to fuck off me?
My toes is fucked up. I'm more comfortable with my socks on. With my socks off, bitch might look at my toes and be like, oh, hell no.
Yo.
Anxiety free.
Yo.
Anxiety free. So your socks are on and you're like, yo, real shit. Get this nut.
I'm good. Like, let me keep my shit on. That's when I'm in my bag.
Facts. Off,
I got to be super comfortable with you. Off.
I was at a pool party this weekend. And I didn't get in the pool because I forgot my water shoes at home. And I wasn't about to put my feet. Like, get in the water. You can't swim.
I can swim, nigga. We dancing around the issue. Are men super insecure about their feet?
Yes.
OD.
Facts.
OD.
I'm not that insecure.
I am.
You got pretty feet?
I mean.
Yo, pretty feet having ass, nigga.
Show your toes, nigga. You a real nigga. Show your toes then, nigga. Take them socks off, nigga.
Toe checks.
Yo, wait for it. The who hurt you, bro, feet find is coming. Let's go.
I ain't going front. I ain't gonna lie, I was looking at niggas' feet. I was looking at mad niggas' feet this weekend. And I was like, yo, I'm down bad. Like,
oh, niggas' feet look better than your feet?
Yeah.
Oh.
You gotta pretty up your feet?
That's everybody like was hopping. Like, you can't swim, you a friend. I'm like, no, I could swim, bro. I'm in my head like, yo, I need the perfect opening so I can
even if you got slides on, you still not valid?
Nah, I need water shoes.
Facts.
Like, I need water
kicks. I don't
like
my toes out.
So, and I'll go into the bathroom, put them shits on, and come back out.
I'll be rocking water shoes, bro. It goes from fucking laced out forces, because that's what you wear to the beach, right? Laced out forces, no laces on your forces. Mm-hmm. They beat and shit, you get them. You walk on, you know what I'm saying? Then you put on your fucking swim shoes, and then you out.
No laces on your foot. You just left the bookends?
I mean, I think that's probably where I picked it up at.
At least you're being honest.
I ain't gonna lie to you. I've rocked socks on the beach. I'm super insecure. Well, I've always been super insecure about my feet. I think Tatiana, Mama in the chat said, bro, wasn't Tahoe insecure until Shorty sucked them? Maybe that's what everybody else needs. No, I'm still insecure.
Yeah, I know my shit's ain't valid.
don't like people looking at. I know I'm going to get judgment. Facts. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But
don't look at my feet. Don't touch my feet.
My thing is this. Like, I wonder how much. Where is it? Where is our? Where is the security level of being able to take off your socks in front of a woman? Where like, is what mine? Is she done? What happens to you? Say, you know what? I don't care anymore.
I have to call her wifey. I mean, you know, if I don't call her wifey, you never see my feet. Them shits is a mystery to you. It's a mystery.
It's like the hidden existed in whole relationships and never she's never real seen shit. My feet.
Hell no.
My feet are like the hidden character in a video game. You never see my feet.
I'm gonna keep it a buck. I'll give a chick bread for what you see my feet.
Talk your shit, King.
Keep it a buck. I'll pay for you to get your nails and hair done. I'll even trick off for you before I show you my feet, bro.
Facts.
I done had chick. Listen, you
take my card.
I done had a chick eat my ass and not even see my feet.
That's crazy.
Keep it 100. Like my feet is that is the most intimate thing I can ever do for you. You know, like, damn, I'm not about
to. You ever had a chick put your toes in her mouth?
No, I never had that.
No, I don't think I would even want that. I had a chick. I don't want to let chicks massage my feet like that.
Because of how ugly they are?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm keeping it 100. I don't got cute feet, bro.
You got ugly feet?
Oh, my toes.
Ugly?
My
toes
between like
on a scale of 1 to 10, like 10 being the worst, my shit is definitely at like
onions and shit?
Nah, I just have dark toenails.
Yeah, I do too. Yeah, I'm right. Yeah, there.
I have. You got gray or green?
Black looking. Like fake. Like you ever see like the fake, like Oakland Raiders? Like,
yo, this nigga like, said got he's Oakland, got the Las toes. Vegas Raiders. You know what fucking I'm toenails is crazy.
I keep it 100, bro. Like, I don't.
So you got I'm black just... Air Force feet.
That's crazy.
Yo.
That's crazy. That's nuts.
My feet are like a black Benz, nigga. Like,
that's crazy. Yeah. He's like, yo, what color is that, Matt? Matt Black.
So let me ask you a question. If a woman were to cherish your feet, like super, like want to rub them, take your socks off, kiss on them, all
that might help.
What would that make you feel like?
Uncomfortable.
It might help you though.
First time, off rip, uncomfortable.
Yeah.
All right, and then after that, she oil them down. She doing all of these things.
Washing, like, scrubbing.
How would that make you feel?
I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna keep it 100. I would have to be asleep and wake up to her doing it.
That's crazy.
So you still won't find yourself vulnerable, even if she's saying, "I love these feet. I love your feet."
Yeah, because I'm gonna be just fronting. Because I don't love these feet. Yeah,
front for me.
You feel me? Like
I don't like.
I'm gonna feel.
My shoe?
Huh? Don't touch my feet. Yeah. Don't touch my feet. Don't look at my feet. I don't even like touching feet because I don't like my feet.
That's how I used to be. Huh? Yeah. I swear to God, that's how.
Yo,
I used
there's
to
like
be.
We have a video out where the shit. I was like, Shorty was like, "Oh, so you don't suck?" She's like, "I was like, I don't suck toes." And she was, "You don't suck toes?" Yeah. And I was like, "No." Like, if they bite my toes? Face, I'm like, "Yeah." And I hold up the, you know what I'm saying, the ankle, and I'm getting it in, but it's away from the fucking face. Like, we're not doing that.
So if a chick feet is ugly, that's like.
She got socks. So we're in the same boat. Now I can feel like we have a bond. Like, you got fucked up feet. I got fucked up feet. High five. Keep your socks on. I'll keep mine on. And we never have to have this conversation ever again.
I'm going to keep it a buck. A chick that feet don't look that pretty don't bother me that much.
Because you can relate.
Yeah.
Nah, because my shit's way worse than
but
her.
But you've never so been seen some pretty ass feet. Like, damn. That's some pretty ass feet. Like,
here's the thing.
Like,
most of the chicks I fuck with, they got night. Like, I'm not afraid of their feet. I'm just afraid of my feet. You feel me? Like,
oh, I gotta answer this one.
What they said?
What about a foot rub? Foot rub, Poppy? No. I'll let you rub my shoulders, my back, whatever you want to rub, you can rub. As soon as you get to my ankle, we have a problem. We're gonna have a disagreement. I'm not gonna deal with it. I'm gonna be like, "Mommy, no, puedo," and then that's it.
So look, so let's move on to the next fact.
I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. I'm on my.
What happened? What she said?
Guy is in here. You know the young lady that lost her legs, and she said, "I have an advantage. I don't have feet to worry about." But she does this all the time. It just goes.
Wait, I salute you.
She lost her legs in an accident.
Damn, that's like
buzzkill.
Oh my, dark ass comedy.
First off, that's dark humor. I love dark humor.
I do too. I like dark humor, but not like when it's the person that's saying it. Like,
why not? You want to make fun of them instead of them saying it?
You fucking demon. Like a room full of everybody with feet. That's a funny joke. But
I'm gonna tell y'all right now, ladies, fuck with my feet. I love it. I mean, especially if you put the big toe, the gray one, in your mouth, I love it.
I'm gonna keep it a buck. Stay away from mine.
But yo, what are y'all hiding behind y'all foot?
Yeah, like, it can't be that bad.
Hiding.
It can't be that
hold
bad.
Hold on,
it can't be that bad.
Let me put it to you like this:
y'all hiding behind this. And y'all not willing to give it up.
Let me put it to you. Let me put it to you like this, right? As God is my witness, let me not put this on. You would have to pay me a serious good amount of money for me to show my feet.
How much?
The first number that came to my head for me to think about is half a mil.
What?
I'm so serious.
But you gave feet to who?
Like to own this podcast? You like if you came to me with 100 racks.
Televising my feet.
If you came to me with 100 racks, I'd tell you no.
I'd do that shit for $1,000.
I wouldn't do it.
$500.
I wouldn't do mine for $1,000.
Mel, you a foot whore, bro. Like,
you got cute feet.
What the fuck you is cute that? Feet like, having ass foot whore.
You got pretty feet. You pretty foot no, swinging ass nice bitch. What's the matter? Did you get your feet done ass down, bro?
Niggas get their feet done start acting mad. Niggas just got a petty. Like, get the fuck out of here, bro. You don't
count. You don't count, nigga. Fuck out of here! Nigga, you
got me
exempt
this bullshit.
You probably you fucking Republican.
Nigga said I got clear on. I got clear on. Who wants to see? I was thinking about doing
why
white tips.
Why you mad though? Why you mad though?
Because my shit is ugly, bro.
My shit beat.
But how can you consider yourself to be vulnerable if you have that one thing that you will not that you're hiding? Like she cannot touch. Like what the fuck? It's not a butthole. I understand that y'all think the butthole is the gateway to gayness, but the foot, what is it doing?
I'd give my ass away if I get my
gateway feet up. To gayness is crazy.
I'd give my ass.
That's a crazy gateway.
That was tough. That was tough. That was actually tough. I'd give my ass away if I get my feet up. I keep it a buck.
What about? All right. What about you? Because he got both those hard nose.
Which one you
asshole
give up
and
first?
Feet? Which one are you giving up first? That's a good ass question for him, bro.
What's happening to the asshole? Let's get everything out in the open before I answer this question. I feel like we need some transparency, and I'm not being provided said transparency. So let's get some
transparency. Face on either one. Face on either one.
Face on either one.
Lick your toes or lick your ass.
Lick my ass before you touch my toes.
Really? That's nuts.
Damn, bro. We really standing
on.
I
mean, I probably would rather that too. Either way, but I would.
I crave foot head.
I never had it before.
nigga said I crave.
I need foot head. You wouldn't use your hand. You would use the other foot to push your head down on it. Like, I'm fucking so confused.
I need some fed. I need some fed.
Send that fed.
All right. But moving on.
What the fuck?
I ain't going front.
Nah, fed is funny.
Some of y'all might have known this one. I, for one, didn't pay attention in science, so I probably didn't notice. It says the egg chooses the winning sperm, right? Mm-hmm. So we all know when you bust in a jaw, it's like a billion of them little niggas in there. And she picked one. Now, I'm going to keep it 100. I was always under the impression that them niggas is fighting each other.
Mm-hmm.
And the nigga that made it was just the toughest one. This shows me that I was wrong.
Get out of here.
It says most of us imagine conception as a race to the egg where the fastest sperm wins and gets the pass on its genes to the baby to be. This is one of those sex facts you should forget, says Jill McDevitt, a human sexuality expert and Cal Exotics resident sexologist. The narrative is biased with our cultural lens about men being competitive. The egg sits around passively, she says. In reality, eggs have sophisticated biological mechanisms that actively choose which sperm they allow in, and it isn't always the first one to arrive. So meaning, you can do all that shit you think you can to be in first place and still not get chosen.
Well, damn, Jill. Tell her what the fuck it is now. I want to know.
I did. That's all they said. It's you don't being
compatibility.
Being first ain't guaranteed. That's what she said.
The egg's able to tell by once the sperm hits the outside of the egg, what winds up happening is essentially it's going to fucking sit there and figure out which one's compatible and then let that one in. The rest just sit out.
Yo.
You ever been at fucking McDonald's and the bitch behind you get to order you? Like, you open the door and the one...
Oh, she gets an order before you?
And she gets in line. Yo, I have a problem with that the whole time.
That bothers the shit out of me.
If the lady says, you know what? No, I want his order. That's what this feels like.
Yeah,
no,
yeah,
let
yeah.
Me get his order.
I want, yeah.
No, you, that's what this feels like. Yeah,
that's what it
give
is.
Give him a griddle?
That's fucked up.
Fuck that bitch.
I would have thought it would have been first come, first serve.
First come, first serve.
It's not, though.
It's not first come, first serve.
It's not.
Imagine a world that's like that.
So imagine how many sad sperm cells is like...
Because what the fuck do the rest of the sperm cells do?
End up in the toilet.
They just get gay.
They just end up in the toilet.
Yo, what about
oh
me
my
bro?
God.
They start pairing up. They're technically brothers. That'd be incest.
We're brothers.
This whole way, nigga. I want some action. Yo, shut like.
You know what's really crazy, though? Like, if you're really not compatible with that person, that egg won't take any of that sperm.
Yeah, I
so
heard
you
that.
Shot that whole load for nothing.
Yeah, a friend. I was talking to a young lady eons ago. And she said her and this nigga she was dealing with was trying to like have a baby and it was fucking raw. She was fertile, all that shit. She tried everything.
4 years I fucking chick raw. Never got her pregnant.
Were you trying to?
No, but I wasn't not trying to
But you were shooting it up though.
Every night. Several times.
She what? Went
that's yeah, insane.
She went to the doctor and the doctor said, yo, y'all just not compatible. Mm-hmm. Certain people, y'all certain
is that shorty pregnant now?
She had a baby.
That's crazy.
Oh, it was really you.
It's just the compatibility.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I didn't even think that was a thing. Like, compatibility really do mean but something
to a certain extent. How many sperm cells we shoot out?
A billion, nigga.
And yeah. you can't find one out of a billion?
They're all based off you.
They're all you.
Yeah, they're all you. There's slight changes in each one.
So which one make one special then? It can't be all me.
I don't know. Ask the egg. Nigga, why you asking me? I'm not at the door of the club. Like, nah, yo, you can come in. Rest of y'all niggas got to go home.
That's what it sounds like, right?
Like if I'm the fire marshal. Yeah. We're overcrowded. Everyone get the fuck out.
Nigga at one oak.
One oak, son. One
sperm. Nigga at one egg.
So I ain't gonna front. One egg is mad funny.
Yeah, I thought of it later.
That was actually good.
Yeah, it was good.
I ain't gonna front. I kind of felt this one to a certain extent. I think you need to hear this one.
Thank you.
Too many solo encounters can make sense with a partner more difficult.
Wait, say it one more time.
Too many solo encounters can make sex with a partner more difficult. Many men suffer from delayed ejaculation, a term used for men who struggle to have orgasms in conventional ways. But it's very seldom discussed, says Cindy Darnell, an Australian clinical sexologist, sex and relationship therapist. Damn, bitch. One reason for this is an, I can't even pronounce this word. Tiana, what is idiosyncratic? Idiosyncratic? What the fuck is that?
Idiosyncratic,
yeah. What? All right, there we go.
What does that mean?
I have no idea. Thank you.
Why didn't you Google it, nigga?
I didn't think that far.
He's like, I'm reading, bro. One thing at a time. The fuck?
I ain't gonna lie. I really had to get out of the bathroom. I didn't think this went through.
Oh, are we still in the bathroom?
No, I did all this in the bathroom.
All right.
You remember how long you had to be there?
No, I was just thinking that shit in my head. I read all of it?
Or you just like, all right, I'm gonna read this on the pod?
This was the last part. I was going to read it.
It's rather unusual.
Okay. Rather unusual masturbation style, which means they've become accustomed to a certain kind of pressure and speed from manually masturbating and now find that difficult to replicate with a partner vaginally or orally making.
That's fine.
For a less than satisfying experience for both partners, they said.
I think most women that use one vibrator.
It's desensitization. Like you're going to eventually get desensitized to anything other than the thing you're normally doing.
Desensitized. I think it's that you get used to the feeling that gives you. And then when you have sex with somebody, it's not necessarily desensitized. It's just that your body knows what to react to. It's almost like you ever watch mad porn and then you start getting late for work and then you go watch the porn that you know.
Yeah.
And you nut just like that.
You know what really makes me mad is that I feel like this nigga's in my head. Because that shit happens to me on the regular. I'm like, I just can't find the right scene. Why shorty ain't clapping it back? Why she slightly cock-eyed? I was like, this shit ain't it.
Is she nutting when she's cock-eyed or not?
No, it was like beforehand.
You was jerking off to Tracy McGrady?
If it was a bitch.
I mean, Tracy, let's be real. So it's your body find certain things very familiar. Mm-hmm. That's it. Yo, like say a lot of chicks say if, a lot of chicks that I've been fucking since I broke up, it's kind of like, whatever. Had sex with my ex? On top, crazy. My body was like, yeah, we back.
Know your timing.
Back. Know your rhythm. Real back. We was crazy. You know what I'm saying? So your body knows what feels familiar. It's not desensitized. Your body just knows it's aligned with certain shit. So women's bodies get aligned with their favorite vibrator or whatever. Mm-hmm. You get aligned with your hand. Your hand knows your body. It's just like, oh, okay, we know what we're doing here.
To be fair, my hand doesn't know my body. My hand's very familiar with my dick, though.
All right. Well,
the way I look at it is like this, right? So me, I'll be cooking and shit like that, right? So one of my favorite shits is like shrimp scampi. So when I make shrimp scampi, I gotta use the shrimp scampi sauce and lemon butter combined. That shit is literally chef's kiss. But if I don't have one, I can't eat it because it's just not what I'm used to. Like the combination took me to here. Mm-hmm. And just having one or none is like an underwhelming experience. You know what I'm saying?
So I be mad at bitches with vibrators? Sorry.
Do I be mad at bitches with vibrators?
Only use this shit all the time?
Only when I've mad, no, but I do be like, damn, like, so you can't know, so I'm fucking you vibrating at the same time all the time. Like, I've had that happen before.
I feel like I would be mad if, like, in the middle of it, she's just like, pull it out, like, as if I'm not doing enough.
So, why you gonna pull it out?
If I pull it out, then
You cool. I wouldn't be. I'm cool. But if she like pull it out, it's like, all right.
But so pull it out thing? First, then, nigga.
It's the same thing.
If she does it, she's substituting him for the vibrator.
Yeah, then I'll be like,
she's like, you need.
But if you're doing it, you're like, I'm just trying to get this shit over with. So bang, hold that on your clip.
Nah, it's a different thing. It's really more so like, yo, this is me pulling on my back to go above and beyond to get you that nut. Yes. You know what I'm saying?
Versus
when she does it, it's more so like, oh, I don't make the cut. Like, I'm not good enough. So it really, damn, who reaches for the vibrator first says a lot.
Hold on. Like, no, that, but y'all are playing some wild mental juju. Like, I have no idea how y'all get, like, if I pick it up or she picks it up, is it the result of like,
you ain't digest the game that we just gave you just there, bro.
So if he's fucking a chick.
Hit the game again, bro. So look, so
he's fucking a chick, right?
Copy.
He's in there. He's stroking it. She goes and reaches for the vibrator and starts zapping her jaw while he doing it. It's really more so her saying, yo, I need something more. This isn't enough.
Yes.
You feel me?
Or at least that's how I.
That's how a nigga might perceive it.
Perception, yeah.
But if he go for it, it's really more so like, yeah, this is me. You feel me? Trying to play my part and do everything that's in my capability to make sure that I take you to the moon and back. You know what I'm saying? It ain't really her doing it. It's his doing it. So because like based on who reaches for it first is who had a desire for more. Did he want to do more? Did she require more?
Yes. Okay. So I thought I already understood this, but I think that's where I'm kind of disagreeing with both, with all of y'all, right?
Because devil's advocate shit.
It might be my devil's advocate shit. But for me, wouldn't you fall into the same trap going the opposite way?
What do you
because
mean?
Because if that's the case and you're hitting it and she hasn't decided to grab the vibrator, maybe she was just really digging your dick and you decide to grab the vibrator, isn't it feeling like maybe you're trying to rush her because she knows that's how she's going to get it?
I mean,
couldn't you fall into that same trap?
No. There's nothing wrong
with it. Your nose are always so strong. And then we go through it and then you change the nose.
Nothing wrong with more. Me wanting to give her more, that's not a bad thing.
You see, I'm going to be honest. My problem isn't with me grabbing the vibrator for her or her grabbing the vibrator for her. My issue is when I grab the vibrator for myself. Then she just looking at me like.
I'm like, yeah. My thing is feeling. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck.
I don't know.
I was wanting one of y'all niggas to say because I was like, I'm talking for a bit. So right.
I was trying to get away from it. But go ahead.
Wait, what you did with it? Like, what you did with the vibrator for yourself?
Hey,
hey, it's not where you put it, Pop. What are we talking about?
I ain't gonna lie. I definitely done caught some neck with a butt plug. You feel me? Plugged in, like out of this world.
What? What's going on?
Wait, we talking about vibrators.
That's so a vibrator. It
was a vibrating butt plug.
Or a vibrating butt plug.
It's like a bullet. Okay. You feel me? And,
but for you.
Yeah. Well, it was hers. I just grabbed it.
And put so it y'all in. You
put
shared
it in.
It.
I put it in her hand. And I moved her hand. And she plugged it in.
But you had a butt. A hold vibrating
on.
Butt
I'm so confused.
Bro, wait, so,
bro, no. Thank so, you. I'm so confused. No, wait, so, I don't know what the fuck is
so
going on.
Shorty came.
Wait, just say it, bro. All right,
so this is what happened. So Shorty came to my crib.
Say it, bro.
I met a little while ago, right? And she came over there with some, she came over to spend the night. So she came with a bag of tricks, right?
Okay.
She had, I believe it was a rose, some lube, and a butt plug.
Okay, a vibrating butt plug.
A vibrating butt plug. So I used it on her, and I'm feeling shit on my fingers. I'm like, yo, this shit kind of tough. Like, I like that, okay. All right. And I'm the kind of nigga, I could kind of piece shit together sometimes before I even actually piece it together. Like, I know certain shit gonna taste good before I even mix it together. So I'm like, yo, do you know what it'll feel, would this shit be fire? I know where this shit'll feel fire, but I don't say nothing to her. So she necking me all crazy, necking me, right? And I'm like, yeah, this shit tough. And I tried to do it on the low, so I hit her with the. You feel me?
And grabbed the butt plug.
I on the low, and then I turned it on, and she said, dick in mouth and all. She's like,
it's a crazy like,
what if she didn't put it inside of her? Like,
No, this is for me.
Well, I'm saying, what if she didn't catch it?
I would have been like, no, this is for me. Like you've had this is about me right now. So I put it in her hand and I moved her wrist and she plugged it in. And I lasted all but about maybe 39 seconds.
Yo, that's dope. Yo, honestly, I'm laughing, but I never thought that you would go that far with facts. This shit.
So
you dead ass let her put a vibrating butt plug in your shit.
Put that on Kobe Bryant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was waiting to get there. What the fuck?
He was going to say it.
I thought
what? Where else you going to put a butt plug?
I thought she was over here rubbing you off the bump. I was so confused because you didn't paint any picture.
I ain't really want to say. I knew where this was going. I said, get the fuck out. Because you're not about to clip me. So I'm like, yeah, you're going to pull it up. But yeah, you feel me?
So, Lou, real quick, where did she put the butt plug?
All right.
We'll be back after this commercial break. But I say that to say, so that's why with me personally, I don't mind. I don't mind who grabs it first.
Gangsta, that's nutty.
Nah, it was like maybe like, it was like a battery, like a double A battery. A little bigger than a double A battery.
Did it have a flat base at the end?
Did it have the jewel at the end? It kind of like a game controller.
Could have swallowed that shit up, bro.
Yeah, it was a little curved.
Did it have the diamond on the flat other end? Did it blink?
It was blue.
It was blue.
It was about the size, a little bigger than a double A battery. And it felt like, I don't want to say rubber. Did it feel like rubber? Like tough rubber.
Silicone, probably.
There we go. Yeah.
Fire.
Tough.
I'm laughing.
How was that experience, though?
I don't give a fuck.
I ain't going to hold you. Son, that shit was tough. Because, like, I'm big on, like, multiple. You ever heard of multiple streams of income? I like multiple streams of stimulation. You know what I'm saying? So, that should be having your body just not knowing what the fuck to do. Nah. It wasn't.
It was the right amount of sensory.
It is for him, right now. He's sitting there like, yeah,
I ain't going front. I ain't going.
There'd
lie,
be a lot
bro.
Of flicks. Stop it! What are you doing? Fuck out of here.
That shit was tough, son. That shit was tough. But
I love that for you, bro.
Yo, shout outs to me.
Nah, big facts.
Shout
big facts.
Can we get it?
Let's get that.
Lose butthole.
Stop. Let's stop.
Plugs in the streets. Let's go.
So what I will say is, right, when I usually jerk off the morning I'm about to get some buns, I don't really be having those crazy nuts like that. But this one felt like I ain't jerk off in days. Like that shit was, it was like a boom. I was like, ooh, child. Shot that one from half.
So that brings up a great question. So like when you sitting here and you beating your shit and you get yours off, right? For me, it's always light. When I'm getting cheeks, even if I get off one light, it's like I just dumped a whole bucket on Shorty. It's fucking nuts. I don't even know how the fuck that's possible.
Yeah, I'm going to say, I don't know why, but for some reason, whenever I nut, it's a lot.
This shit is OD, bro.
Yeah, like, it's it'll probably be like, damn, do I have anything left? Like, I'd be shocked that I'm
regenerating. You be checking this shit, you be like.
Yeah, I'd be like, yo, this shit. I gotta charge a Tesla. But, we're getting closer to the end of the show. So here on the end of the show, we pretty much like to, you know, go to the format basis of what we do. So I want to ask you guys, hopefully you guys read the email. I gave you guys ample time. Mm. So I'm going to start off with you because I gave you the one so you ain't have none. I'm coming to you first.
Start with him.
All right, let's go to Daddy Yankee. So
for the Daddy Yankee comment, I feel like
So what got your dick hard this week?
What got my dick hard this week? Honestly?
Now again, it don't have to just be sexual. It could maybe be something you've seen, someone you've seen, something that was done for you.
I got a really cute end of night text message. And I wound up falling asleep, and I felt like a 13-year-old boy because, like, my shit, when I woke up, it was type A hard, and it was a little wet. You know what I'm saying? Spanish, a little mojado. Estaba mojadito. You know what I mean? Like, I was like, off a text? I was like.
I'm so easy.
Aww. My dick wet for you. Because I got to be sweet. You know what I mean?
Oh,
so,
my God.
But, yeah, that's what got me. It doesn't take much, like, a certain level of caring. I might very well be
fine.
Like, ooh, yeah. Mommy, you like me. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, that's what it is.
You ever say, so damn, I'm mad easy.
100%. I look in the mirror and say that shit. I'm like, you're such a slut.
All right, man. So you up next, man. What got you
for me,
this
week? It was some. I see some shit on the internet. It's some simple shit. I ain't see it in real life, but I'm going to show y'all niggas. It's some simple shit, but I never even seen this before.
I love that. I love it. It's the double cheek drawers.
What's your name?
So I seen this shit.
Yeah, them shits is
fire.
I was
like, yo, I need to see that in real life.
It's a drawer. It's the ladies that when the strap goes around each cheek, but the whole middle part be open.
Oh my God. That's what that you seen that before?
Yeah, I fucked it.
Oh, you seen it in real life?
Yeah. You had them on or they had them on?
I seen it on the internet.
She had them on, bro.
Okay. I'm just asking. You never know.
Today's your butt episode, not mine.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that should have my dick.
You know what that reminds me of? Remember when we said with Maine that sometimes the pictures be better when they got the panties on and the panties off? Mm-hmm. If a girl send me that shit at work, I am leaving work early. I'm having an emergency and I'm leaving work early.
Yeah.
My fish is drowning. I have to go.
Like, I'm losing all self-control.
Yeah, that shit just did. Send me that.
What about the chicks that have the pussy with the pussy opening? It's just the pussy opening.
I love those shits. I love those shits. Like the I feel like it's the audacity of the panties not covering the most important part. And I'm just like, I love it. Just be completely counterintuitive to what the fuck you're supposed to be doing. Let's go. I love this. Give me more of that.
Oh, but so Tahoe.
What made me? I don't know. You
Dick Flair. Pop Strokes. Dick-a-mex.
I think a lot of people would like to hear this, though. So I'm going to say, I was wondering if I was going to say it or not, because it's kind of personal. So, you know, tonight, Gatorade and I talk. We talk often. You know what I'm saying? We still talk.
You don't
talk.
Say.
And I tell her about a lot of my escapades, the sexual things that I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? She said she want to know. So my daughter had a graduation party this weekend.
Shout outs to her.
She's my ex.
We clap it up for her graduation.
Let's go.
Here we go.
And so afterwards, Tanae and I, we retired to my place and we started drinking. And I said, yo, you always ask me about what I'm doing, but you never say what you're doing. It's been almost 2 months we've been broken up. Like, what you, and she was like, I was like, you've been taking dick? She told me about one instance where she had something. Okay. I started feeling like warm down below. And she told me about another instance, same person, whatever. And I got hard.
This is your ex.
I said, yo, take your clothes off. She was like, what? Because I was scared. I know you ain't want to hear that. I said, yo, I'm fucking hard. I want to fuck you now. The fact that you felt that comfortable telling me that, and the fact that we could just sit here and just talk about the shit. I don't really feel jealous. I'm happy for you. I'm happy that you. I don't know if I was happy for her getting dick.
That would have been tough.
But I was happy that she felt comfortable enough to tell me. I feel like that's a breakthrough that we never really had in all the time. Even like when we was open or whatever, I wouldn't never felt comfortable telling her what I was doing. That's why part of the reason that I felt like we should separate is because it's like, yo, I feel like I'm cheating. You know what I'm saying? But if we got to the point where we could share these things with each other and still feel sensual with each other,
so you was able to get what you wanted, even though y'all wasn't together.
Yeah, like, like this is what I was asking what you wanted for the whole time. I want to be able to talk to you. I want you to, you know, and nigga, we wilded out in here that night, and I didn't think about it twice. I swear to God, I never thought about it twice. And then I started playing Give Me On, still your best. I don't know. Love it or hate it.
I hate Giveon.
Yeah, I play that nigga.
You know, that's so fire.
But because it is fire.
You know why that's fire? And it's not fire because she was out here just fucking somebody else. But it's the fact that you were, like I always say all the time, son, it's not too many things that I can't really deal with. But yo, a girl that could keep it real with me, roll with me, we could have that uncomfortable conversation. The fact, I know you're not perfect. I know you're going to do you. Like, you're human. The fact that you could dead ass strip naked, and I don't mean physically, I mean emotionally and spiritually, and we could talk about that, that's big fire. That's kind of what got my, well, I could see why that would get your dick hard.
And she really, she was talking about it, and she was like amazed by it. Like you could see it in her face, like, you serious? I was like, yeah, take your clothes off right now.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Real shit. I fuck with that.
That shit was fire. Hard so body. That's what made me, that's what, yep.
Mm-hmm. He said, yep. Mm-hmm. So, got my dick hard. So this was probably one of the more nicest things a girl is, or thoughtful things a girl has ever done for me. So I was driving in the car one day, and me and the girl that I'm dealing with, and I heard like, you know, some music, playing.
I was gonna say it, but I was like, nah, I ain't gonna do it.
Chill out. Yeah. So I heard some music playing, right? And I'm sitting here like, oh yeah, this shit tough. You feel me? Next song, some Drake. I'm like, oh shit, fire.
I think I see where you're going with it.
And the next one was Future. And I'm like, oh, this is my shit though. You feel me? And then the next one was a song that I know for a fact she wouldn't know. Only I know the song. So I'm like, yo, how do you know this song? It's like, yeah, I saw you have posted on your Instagram a couple weeks ago.
Oh,
and when I look at the dash, the playlist is called Loon's Playlist.
She lined you
up. She made a playlist for me with songs that I actually liked. That was the toughest shit I have ever seen
like
in my life.
That's fine.
That was tough.
That's the borderline.
That's a little creepy and fire at the same time, though. That's
tough. Too much. Shorty, fall back.
That's tough.
My man right here. Fuck out of here. You're doing too much.
Yo.
She's encroaching on my territory.
That was so tough. You know how hard it is to connect on some music shit? Like, imagine, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, each shit was like some shit.
Get out. Look, say
what they said.
Tell them, get out.
I'm fucking
get out. Go, bro. She's trying to, she's laughing when you. You don't even know. Oh, man. She's around you. She's trying to fucking get you.
Bob and Weaver, man. But I bet. So now we like to get into what we call the hard. The things that men like about sex. Fuck that. The things that we love about sex. Mm-hmm. So again, we're here with Who Hurt You, Bro podcast. That make us... Yeah, there we go. I knew I was forgetting something. The things that make us hard.
That's right.
Or wet.
Depending on what you like.
Though. Men get wet too. You feel me? As you can see. Your little text message, so I had to. So
I'm saying, I don't know why you pointed at me like it was currently happening. I looked down. Like,
nigga, look down.
I'm dry, right? I'm dry.
So, what is your heart, bro? Pause.
Thank you for pausing that.
Appreciate it.
Really opened it up for me to be able to speak about it now. Thanks.
I opened it up for you?
Pause.
Yo, do your thing, bro.
Yo.
Do
your thing. Crazy shit, the thing that gets me hard is talking. Like I'm aggressive. I'm like an incredibly aggressive person with jokes, having conversations. I just tend to be aggressive.
A nigga with a Puerto Rican flag? Couldn't tell.
Nah, right? It's not in my genes. Right. So I like when I get it as much as I give it. Pause.
Okay. So you like that same energy?
I like shorty to be aggressive. Like, yo, you gonna give me that? Oh yeah. Oh, you gonna fuck me like that, daddy? I'm like, oh. Like, yeah. Oh, one more time.
Come
say
eat,
it again.
Come eat these empanadas, nigga.
If that's pussy, yes. Yes, sir. And we call them patelillos. Stop it. All right? So, you know what I mean? Like, those are the things. I love that shit. I love women who can match my energy. I love that shit. So, as soon as I start hearing that aggressive, I get aggressive. And then now we really just sit here.
Like, I just fighting each other.
Essentially, yeah. But, you know what I'm saying?
So, not to get too personal, can you give us, like, a little recap of, like, a verbal sexual exchange you had with a lady that sticks in your mind, like a good rounder? A sexual verbal foreplay or something.
Mm. I wouldn't call it foreplay because it's pretty fucking crazy. So she goes, and we were having a back and forth about something stupid. I think it was like some political shit that we were talking about. Because, you know, she gets in her bag. I like that shit because then I get to joust with you like intellectually on things that, you know, I believe in, she believes in. And then, you know, we can kind of find a middle ground. So, you know, we got a little heated. She got upset. And I was like, yo, shake it off. You're going to be all right. Gotta be a dickhead, right? So I felt good about myself saying it. And then she comes back and she was like, well, you know what you could do right now? Stick out your tongue and stick it in this pussy. And I was like, and that's it. It's over. I was down to my drawers in a heartbeat, bro. I was fully dressed.
That's fire.
I flew. And I'm not that athletic no more, Poppy. Oh. So for me to do it was more than any salsa dance that I ever did in my life. Well, I was I y'all shook it off. Boy.
Come here then.
I was all over that shit.
That's a different bond though.
The thing is I love that shit. I literally love that shit. And that's what pisses me off when I hear people talking other shit about women are too aggressive. If you can't enjoy someone matching your energy, you are missing the fuck out. Mm. You're missing out. If she could give it as good as she get it, I love it. Mm.
Damn, okay. That just fucked me up. A lot of times, once we get to that point where we arguing and shit, I'm like turned off. But I think I'm turned off because I don't want you to cut me off because we got there. Mm-hmm. But if you could actually be like, now fuck me, nigga.
It changes the whole dynamic. That same energy you
still
have.
You like me after that? Woo. Or you still want me after that? You just want to get your shit off? I'm not sure if I've dealt with that.
Because when you think about it, whenever you have like argument sex, it's usually like a space in between. Like maybe it's like the next morning. Yeah, or something. Yeah. He went like direct. It's like a transition. Right now, still, I've never done that before.
I still am accepting you. I still want you right now, even though you're a bitch ass nigga for what you said.
Yo, it's
crazy.
I've never done that.
To be fair, that's something that you foster, right? Like having really good communication, and especially for like things like, especially if you're argumentative. Mm-hmm. A lot of New York women in general are argumentative.
You don't say.
Right? It don't matter if you just behind her trying to get a bacon, egg, and cheese and you talk over her to Ock, she's going to get tight, right? So they're automatically argumentative, making her feel as comfortable as you can possibly be to sit there and be able to voice whatever your disagreement is in a space where you don't have to feel like someone's coming at you. Mm-hmm. And even if they do, you don't have to take it personal. And right afterward, whip out the dick and then she on it. It's fucking fire.
Son, yo, I literally had an argument last night with a chick I'm talking to. And in the argument, she was like, I mean, I don't give a fuck. I fuck with you. I still am. This is some bullshit that you doing this, any of it. And her saying, because we knew. This is like literally our second date. We ain't have to argue that hard, but I started it. But fuck it. We was on it. And the fact that she said, I still am. You still here even though we arguing right now?
Yeah.
I felt light after that. I was like, oh, because I thought I was fucking this whole shit up.
Okay.
Yo. I thought I was fucking this whole shit up with this fucking argument. So that shit made me feel like I get it. I totally get that shit.
Somebody telling her, suck my dick. It's like, okay.
Nah, I ain't tell you suck
it's dick. Like, oh, really?
Nah, it's when you say it aggressively and you get an aggressive response back. Yeah. Yo, suck my dick. So whip like, it I'm going to take that shit the whole way down. I'm like, oh.
So whip it out.
Okay. Like, that'll take you completely out of it.
Because what do you say after that?
Nothing. Yo, you gotta pull out your dick. There's no more conversation.
Like, how do you combat that? Like,
you gotta back your shit up.
But is it like, do it then. Is it like a line, though? Or she could just be super duper aggressive the whole way through?
I mean, at that point, if you've opened the door, you have to be accepting of what you've actually asked for.
So no line.
Obviously, you're not going to be like, yo, fucking slap me up or some shit like that, unless you're into it. You know what I mean? Some people are. Right, I told you, I didn't know I was into that choking shit until Shorty did it to me, and I was just like, oh.
Okay, so now we're here with
this nigga pulled that shit out of just something.
Yo, King, are you like clawing yourself?
This shit is nuts, bro.
Yo, again, if you would like to see what Tahoe is doing to himself, please,
I'm not doing anything.
Please just come to the YouTube, to our it's new nuts. YouTube at the Hard of Soft Show. Again, we have a new YouTube, so I'm gonna make this clear. If you see the video is a short mid 6 minute, just look in the video description, click on the new YouTube link to see Tahoe clawing himself and drinking horny juice in front of our guest. Yo, stop.
And electrocuting myself.
And electrocuting his
going the whole route.
Okay,
do this for y'all. I do it for the people.
And if you'd like to see this live, please make sure that you join our Patreon. Again, we can't force this enough. Helping us, we help you. The more of you guys that join our Patreon, the more better quality content we have, the more shows we can do, the more parties we can have. We're about to drop the best. I'm calling it right now. We're about to drop the best Patreon episode of all times.
Yeah, we dropped Zach yesterday.
Best Patreon episode of all time.
Correct. I'm calling it so far.
You think Zach was better than my threesome story?
Yes.
You did?
Yes.
You give him like a little sneak peek of what Zach was talking about?
Yeah, Zach was nuts.
Nah. You gotta pay for that.
You gotta pay for Zach. Shout out to my boy Zach Fort Green, Zach, man.
So go pay for that.
Pay for that.
Telling you. But we have www.patreon.com/thehardorsoftshow.
Show.
And get on that 15.
But you gotta type it in though. You're not gonna just search us. You gotta type it in, right?
Yeah, you gotta type it in. It's 18 get on that top tier. You get all of the benefits. Yeah.
Get it top tier. Get on top.
That's tier. Right.
See what I like. No? All right, fuck it. So here with you now, my friend.
All right, so hard, right?
Correct. Don't look me in my eyes when you say that, though. Don't do that.
That's wild.
He looked at me and smirked.
My man locked eyes. No. Hard, right?
Looked at me and smirked. I'm like, oh, this is me. Look, this is me. This is me. I'm like, yeah, facts, bro. Yeah, facts.
The fuck, nigga? Nah, for me, it probably would be like communication in the bed.
Oh my god.
Cause like I've had sex sometimes and like she's moaning, but she's not really talking to me. Like I wanna hear like her telling me what she want or calling me names or like directing me and helping me go where she need me to go. So like I don't like quiet sex.
I don't like that.
I don't like quiet sex. I need either loud moans and talking. So that would be hard.
What happens if she was mute?
I'm probably not gonna do it if she mute.
Thought I'd ask. You know what I mean? Never know when that might happen.
I can't do quiet sex. I ain't gonna lie. It's something about a good exchange that's like really fire. You know what I'm saying? Like I don't like quiet sex. Like I like talking, but like I want my dick to be so fire you can't even process no thoughts. So, like, I remember one time I was in some shorty, and she was talking. She goes, yo, I just love the way you, oh, my God. You can't even finish no sentence when I'm in that thing. Like, that's when I know, like, I'm really doing some shit.
You want to fuck her into a stutter?
Into a twister, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, I get it, but I really like when you Yeah. I take all your capabilities. Like, yeah, you can't even talk.
That's why I like when chicks try to talk on the phone while I ask them to talk on the phone. Answer the phone.
When you, when you in it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'm doing that shit.
Yeah.
You ever do it?
Yo, nigga, you got to. I'm going to answer
it. That shit motivate me.
You're going to answer it further?
Yeah. I'm going to make you hang on the phone up.
Yeah.
Suppose it's her boyfriend.
Yeah. You're going
to. I don't care who it is. Grandma.
Because I'm going all the way up.
The grandma's crazy.
Answer it.
The grandma's crazy. That's nuts. Grandma's in the hospital. You go take this dick.
You're diabolical, bro.
I was just stressing.
You don't have no respect.
That's fucking crazy. Yo.
You're disrespectful.
Oh, my God.
Yo, because you come on.
Like, nobody beats when the family feuds, bro.
Don't answer the phone while, like,
don't. Don't. We're not going to go on that route.
I'm just joking.
Some things got to be off limits.
Yes. Like my grandmother, nigga. You know what I'm saying? R.I.P. to her.
Please. Let's get to the soft, bro. Let's get to the soft. We run out of time.
I bet y'all. So now we're on the opposite end of the spectrum. The soft. Things that niggas dislike, the things that men dislike, the things that men hate about sex, the things that get our dicks soft.
Yeah, just do it. Just
fuck it. So now we gonna reverse cowgirl this thing. Start off with you first. That was a little wild, but we here though. So what are some things that gets you soft, man?
Some things that get me soft.
Show is fire today.
I ain't gonna lie. Smells. Like, it don't even gotta be. I mean, obviously, if she smelled, that's a bad
thing. I know what you think about.
But it's not even just her. Like, if the room don't smell good either, that's part of it for me. God, like, I'm big on smells. Like, I need it to at least smell good. Like, I need to smell good.
You know what's crazy? I'm more alarmed at a chick who got a smelly room than a smelly box. Cause you can have you can have an off day, but then you just don't upkeep your crib. Like,
that shit smell like socks and shit.
Yo, like, I know you got dirty laundry in the corner.
I can smell the roaches. See
it.
In here.
I can smell it. Yeah,
I smell the roaches in the bitch crib.
Yo,
the project days. They got that like yesterday.
You know no roaches in.
You know that it's a boric acid somewhere.
You gotta look at this shit, my nigga.
That shit's around the fridge. It's around the fridge,
bro. That's how I felt about Shorty. Who there was this one Shorty I was fucking with. I stopped fucking because she was lying. Every time I came to her crib, she was always in the process of cleaning up, but it was never cleaned. Like, it was always a dustpan here with dust hair, but the dust is in the pan and shit. I'm like, yo, listen, I'm not fucking with this. You got stains on the ceiling. Who got stains on the ceiling, my nigga? How do you get food on the ceiling, bro?
Hey, it's coming through the top floor.
No, it was ragu sauce.
How do you know it was ragu?
Because I know what it looked like.
Tasted it?
I know what it looked like. You smell it. You know what ragu looks like, nigga?
This is marinara on me. This is crazy.
Or ragu or Chef Boyardee. It was
lasagna.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It was on this part, nigga. It was red.
Damn. Yeah, all right, sorry.
Pussy blood. Okay.
Let's go.
Yeah, right, it smells for me. It smells for me.
Let's keep it moving along.
So, for me? Oh, man. It's fucking nuts. Unnecessary lies.
Lies?
Unnecessary lies.
Like, which you got the biggest dick in the world?
That would actually hurt my feelings because I know that's not true. I mean, like, don't lie to me like that. Now I know you're blatantly lying. Yo, fuck out of here, right? Sorry. No, but the lies that don't have anything to do with anything. Like, you're just doing it for the sake of doing it. Like, I know you have a nigga and you're like, oh, well, you know, we're not really together right now. Bitch, I don't care. We're just fucking. Like, why are you making this more difficult than it needs to be? It's an unnecessary lie. I'm no longer into doing this. You're making things more than they need to be.
Yeah.
As soon as I have to now sit here and think further than just fucking you, when I've already sat here and was like, I think we're where we need to be at, right? Mm-hmm. I don't care what your personal situation is. You don't care what mine is. Yeah. We have a common sense agreement. Everything's working out really well. Don't sit here and give me nonsensical lies. You'd be better off not telling me shit than sitting here and lying to me. You're just going to fucking sit here and fuck up the whole vibe.
Yeah. I hate a nonsensical lie. I hate when a person is telling me I'm lying when I'm telling them the truth.
Oh, my God. That's annoying. Yo,
that shit make me look annoying at you like, yo, you got so much trust issues. I'm telling you the truth. And you're going to, because you've had PTSD or whatever, or it's been in your head that I'm doing some other shit, you're going to convince yourself that I'm lying. And that shit make me feel like, yo, you just a weak bitch.
And
like,
I'm out of here.
You just, I can't, I don't like, I ain't going to say I don't like weakness, but I don't like when people can't see their weakness. You can't admit to it. Like, you're convincing yourself that it's the other person when it's literally you have on jaded glasses.
Ooh,
jaded. So you're seeing everything is red when nothing is fucking red. It's not. I'm telling you the fucking truth. Mm-hmm. But because you have on these jaded glasses, because you cannot get over or whatever, you have trauma that won't allow you to just believe what a motherfucker is saying, you're seeing shit is red and it's fucking not. Facts. I hate that shit.
Facts. Bringing baggage into relationships is crazy.
Baggage, yeah. Right?
Like bringing previous baggage into new relationships. Oh my God, son.
That's not the part that bothers me. Bringing your previous bag, the issue is you have to be able to sit there and confront it. Mm-hmm. Like, deal with it.
Or at least try.
You know, or be honest. Again, yeah. Be honest about it. Yo, listen, these are my you know, my insecurities. This is where I'm at. Triggers, yep. I'm working toward it. Yep. If you catch me, just put me up on game. You know what I mean? But at the same time, like, whenever that's been said to me, right, or vice versa, you know what I'm saying, that could be used as a weapon. So, you're playing a really crazy tightrope game, right? But if you want to do it, just go all out, man. Yeah. Stop holding back and sitting there fucking up something potentially cool.
Yeah. It's a fact.
Facts.
If you have... So now we at the ending of our episode. We like to call this part just a tip.
Wait, I got us off.
Oh, you got us off?
I think I do.
I didn't think you did.
I don't like... So if I'm just going to go straight sexual, if I don't like when a woman is so insecure about her body that she don't want to take her shirt off or that she don't like everything is kind of like covering up. Because how can you be 100% invested in this moment if you're like trying to hide your true self from me? Like, I don't enjoy that. I fucked with you because I like the way your fupa look, or like I know you're bigger, or I know I fuck with you the way you are. You don't fuck with you the way you are, so because of that you can't really commit to where we are right now. Confidence is sexy as fuck.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Be that confident, even in the way that you was talking about, yeah, I'm a hoe, and that now kind of fucked up the whole, all the niggas, the way they talked about her and all that, because she was confident about it. That shit is more, I like a hoe that admits she a hoe than a hoe that don't.
Ooh, yo,
that's a clip right there.
Woo,
you know what I'm saying? I'd rather you say, yeah, I like fucking and sucking niggas and doing about my, yeah, all right, yo, you know what?
Me next.
I need that.
Yo, where do I get my ticket number at?
Where do I sign up? Where do I sign up?
And I don't really enjoy, and I've had that situation where there's a woman I was super attracted to, and she didn't, like, you know, she kept pulling her shirt down. She didn't want me to see certain shit. Or during sex, she wanted to keep her shirt on. I'm like, yo, take that shit off. She's like, no. So she tried to hold herself. And I'm like, yo, how can you possibly be giving yourself to me if you're not willing to share the full thing? Like, what is this? Why are you, at what level of that? And that's you with your feet, by the way. What level do I have to get to be for you to?
No, he's right.
I don't know why we went with.
No, he's right.
That's you with your feet.
Right, like he pointed to you, like you the same shit, right?
Singled you out.
I like when a person is confident and not scared to just be themselves, and that's spiritually, emotionally, mentally, physically as well. That shit makes me so.
You wrote that down somewhere, didn't you?
Nah.
I was going.
You on a roll today?
I was going.
What a fucking role. That was some shit I would have said.
You're hosting so well. It gives me a chance to just.
I haven't hosted in so goddamn long.
Yeah, I enjoy it. Shout out to the people that's out there. Yo, y'all do realize that Luna's been controlling the whole goddamn show. We spoke about it, and I'm like, yo, do your thing. I have like 100% confidence in you, my nigga. And I'm enjoying the show. Go ahead.
Yeah. So now we're at the closing part. I'd like to call this part just a tip. So pretty much for the listeners that are out there, of all shades, sexes, or whatever the case may be, what is a tip that you guys would like to give them? So before, I'm gonna give you guys some time to think, because Tahoe just gave me a tip that I would like to use. Yo, embrace their insecurities, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't nigga, like,
so that mean you taking your socks off next time you're in the bed with a lady, right?
Embrace them. That's what I mean, toes. Right? Embrace your black toes, my brothers. Wakanda forever.
Where you found? I mean, you said it.
You know what I mean? Foot conda forever.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, that's funny.
Yo, Wakanda is crazy.
Fucking nuts, bro.
Wakanda is tough, bro. But yeah, you feel me? Yo, rub that nigga feet, not mine though. Yo, lick her tiger stripes, my nigga. I love some stretch marks on that ass, nigga. I lick them pregnancy stretch marks too, my nigga. Mm-hmm. Like, you feel me? Like, yo, I love all of that shit. You know what I mean, nigga? I like the smell of let me smell you. Yeah. Come here. You know what I'm saying? Like, embrace people in their natural state. You know, sometimes he or she or they or them might have a hard time maybe being secure in themselves, you know? So you know what? If you really fuck with them, help them. Nigga? You know what I'm saying? If you really, really fuck with them, then help them. You know what I mean? Sometimes you got to teach. So once in a blue, you might have to show people how to love them by loving them. Mm. You got to accept. You sometimes you got to set the example on how people should love themselves by how you love them. So, yo, go out there and, yo, sometimes you got to love on them. You might not love them, but love on them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? To the point where it's so contagious, they love on themselves. So, yeah, that's my tip, man.
Ooh, this nigga's on fire.
That's my tip, man. That's
this
my tip.
Fire.
That's my tip.
He's
for the
on
day,
fire.
Man. That's my tip, man.
Yo, I feel sorry whoever that has.
Yeah, I follow up. Mine's is actually really simple. I mean, it's not gonna be as well thought out or eloquent as you sat there and delivered yours.
He wrote it in the bathroom.
Right? He wrote it in the bathroom. he had mad time to do it. I did it, right? But what I'm gonna say is it's the end of August right now. We're going into September. The temperature's gonna start dropping. Ladies, this one's for the ladies, and I'm gonna move it over to the men.
For the ladies.
Ladies, start bagging up your thick nigga now.
For real.
I'm taking applications, so it's always out here for that. But, you know what I'm saying? I know a lot of thick niggas that are looking for them. Get them now so that you warm for the winter. Cuddles is always the best with a thick nigga. It's just how it goes. The food's always better because we know all the spots. Get on it ASAP. For my big dudes, you know what I'm saying? Get on your game now. Make sure you got the triple goose downs. Tim's all winter long and have all the restaurants on deck, all right? All the restaurants on deck. I'm going to start posting them shits on the Who Hurt You Bro page. Check out the IG. I'm going to have most fire restaurants for dates all winter long. We talking about Spanish food. We talking about Caribbean food. We talking about Indian food. We hitting everywhere, bro. We hitting all the continents. We killing it, son. We hitting the islands, the continents. Shit, if we can go to the moon, we doing that
passport,
too.
Passport bros.
This is cheating.
It is.
He's cheating.
He not even selling dick, nigga. You selling life.
Yeah. Facts.
The fuck
she is.
So I want to date you.
Nigga, you taking bitches to Peruvian spots?
Oh, nigga, I can't even spell that, nigga. What you had for lunch today? Saudi Arabian?
Let's go.
What the fuck that mean? It was spicy.
Shout out to the fat poppies and all that. Yeah, man. They really do. I take lessons from them, the way that they treat women. Always making sure that they're comfortable, making sure that they eat, making sure that they drink. These niggas be taking care of your bitch.
Him and Zach would be perfect.
They really be taking care of your bitch, and we be like, oh, you know, whatever, whatever. But they really find pleasure in making sure they all right, because they all right. They need to eat. They word. Like to drink. Word. They like to do this shit. Word. So the bitch just like being around him because he's vibes.
It's just always better when you eating with somebody else and you want to know what happens. It starts with, oh, we should kick it one time. And next thing you know, I'm in a throat. I'm in a guts. It's just how it works out, because you know what? Food is the opening, you know what I'm saying? The opening salvo of some really great things.
This is why I be feeding bitches. Y'all think I'm playing? This is why I be feeding bitches. I be like, you want something to eat? You want an appetizer? You want a
Pineapple dessert? Express?
Just don't order dessert if you know you're not fucking with me. If you know for sure you're not.
Well, if I'm not getting an answer, you order a dessert, I'm slapping that shit off your hand when we leave.
I'm going to keep it a buck. If you order the dessert and don't give me no buns, we're going to have a problem.
Nah, I agree with
that. It's if you already know. You don't have to give it to me tonight.
Yeah, but if you know I'm not the one.
You already know it's never going to happen. Why are you ordering a Chipotle?
Don't disrespect
me. Fucking ice cream. Like, nah.
You ever had a chick not give you no buns, but she took food home?
All the time. But I'm cool.
You don't slap that shit out their hand like by accident. You be stretching like, don't ever call me again.
Taking food home and giving me no buns, that is a federal offense and it's punishable by law, my nigga.
You go ahead, take your food home. Oh, my God.
Sorry about that. But anyway, man, give us a tip, man. Give us a tip.
A tip? I don't even got a tip, but
it's all right.
Think of one. I guess it'd be like,
go sexual with it. Show, just give us one of your motherfucking crazy moves that you do.
Give us a play. Your go-to play. This is a guaranteed bucket.
Guaranteed
bucket. Kobe fadeaway.
That put the pressure.
Kareem Skyhook, nigga.
Right now.
Give us what's your Kareem Skyhook?
Kareem Skyhook. So off rip, I'm going candles.
Yeah, candles.
Because I like smell. And big, I'm pretty sure candles. She likes smell too.
Every room.
And then I like candles because it's double. It's smell and it's light. So you can turn the lights out and kind of get, you know, a little vibey. Then I'm going music. That's the vibe, right? Set the vibe first, right? Mm-hmm. Then, then, I don't know.
Okay. So can't. So you.
I'm gonna set the vibe.
Environmental first. Stimulation.
Yeah.
Okay. What's playing? What's on right now?
A song playing?
Yeah. What song?
Still your best, I know.
You better just get out with this fucking Give Me On.
Give Me On?
Love Give Me On.
With some Sade? We got Sade?
Sade.
I like Sade. I like Sade.
What, nigga? She old. I'll bring her old box over here. I'll knock the fucking AARP off that see. Shit.
You got.
Damn, you taking the discount off? That's crazy.
Janae Aiko.
Some SZA?
I like Janae Aiko over SZA.
Some SZA?
Janae. I like Janae Aiko. Essential, bro. Essential. Okay. Because SZA talk about killing you and shit. I'll
be here for that.
That's it.
Smoking on my X-Pack tonight.
Yeah, her and Summer, I'm good. Fucking Usher that.
Y'all fucked R. Kelly still?
Or was nah.
We don't do R. Kelly now.
Even though he's the greatest of all time, by the way. Yeah. He is the greatest of all time.
But no.
But nah, we can't fuck.
We can't jive.
That nigga's checking the temperature.
That nigga's trapped in the closet.
It's tough.
He's trapped in the closet. He can't come out.
No, I'm sorry. His songs are slappers. You can still listen to them. There's certain ones that might be questionable. You're going to be like, ain't Jake nothing on a number. You know what I'm saying? Shit like that. You're going to have to be like, this is off the playlist. But for the most part, you can play most of it. Everyone loves Feeling on Your Booty and Step in the Name of Love. You know what I mean? Like, I Believe I Can Fly. I can keep going. It's going to be a waste of time.
No, I ain't absolutely not.
I'm going to be honest. I was never a fan even prior to that. So
you wasn't a fan of R. Kelly?
You wasn't listening to Fiesta? Fiesta? Are you crazy?
The most R. Kelly I ever listened to was The Best of Both Worlds, to be honest.
This is a remix edition.
But I'm not fucking like, R. Kelly.
Like, yo, what?
I never had R. Kelly in my
playlist.
How
do you fuck to R. Kelly?
I can't fuck.
Honey Love is tough though. Ain't gonna front. Honey Love is tough.
Wait,
Honey is like some sweet shit, and that reminds me of some young shit, and it's just like, nah, I can't do it.
No, I don't.
Honey
do
Love, yeah. I grew up to.
It's tough.
I was a young nigga when Honey Love came out. I can't do it just because of the references to sex and me knowing what the person who's singing it wants. I can't do it. But we ain't got to get into all this.
Yeah, that's a different story for a different day.
Yeah, it's a whole different
thing. You got a tip for us or are we good, man?
I'm going to walk in the other room for a minute to get some. All right. So I'm really fucking with. So, my dick been really. I've been my whole life. Dick doing what it's doing. You know what I'm saying? And.
Dick be dicking?
I'm doing what I'm doing. But, you know, as I said, I'm trying to get to different levels now. I'm 50 years old. I'm just trying to get. I've been fucking for 40 years. 35, something like that. Right, 33.
Who's counting?
Yeah, it's
been a while.
Around 17, 18, whatever. So I started getting some box. And I've been starting to do other things, especially since I got out of a relationship. When I was in a relationship in the last couple months or a year or whatever, it was just lazy. I just wasn't really doing much. I wasn't really eating box like that. I just wasn't really doing much. And she, you know, she was feeling that shit. And now that I'm out, you know, feeling back myself again, it's kind of what I said to her when I was there. Like, I just don't feel like myself. I'm just a whack nigga right now. I don't want to be a whack nigga no more. You know what I'm saying? So I got out that relationship. And I've been feeling like myself again. When she was here, I covered her face in the mask. And after, what did I do to her? Did the massage and all that. And then I wanted to go in the other room and get some tools, some sex toys. But I said to her before I went in the room, I said, I want you to lay here, through the mask. Like, her body's already trembling. And I said, I want you to think about the best sex you've ever had in your life. I said it through the mask. I said, how he touched you. How you felt when you came. Sorry, Loon. I have to look at you. You asked me. I have to look at you. I said, how you felt when you came. I want you to think about every thrust. I want you to wish that on yourself. I want you to want that tonight. That same feeling right now. And then I faded. I didn't walk away. Like, I made sure that she couldn't hear my footsteps.
What are you, Bane?
This nigga's Batman.
He floated out.
Nigga, nigga's Prince.
The fuck? Prince, right?
They say Prince never goes where he just goes away and smoke.
My nigga. my nigga, I stood there, right? She didn't know where I went. I stood there for about 3 minutes. She didn't know where I went. Nigga, her body starts convulsing. Her body starts convulsing. Like, and I'm looking like, get the fuck out of here. Like, that shit worked? You know what I'm saying?
The first time you used it?
Huh? That's the first time. Like, I've done voice shit before. Mm-hmm. But then I slowly went off into the other room. Hold on.
This nigga's disappeared in the smoke like Batman, for real.
I'm telling you, son. This, yo, shit is crazy.
Y'all ever seen the shows where you talking to a nigga and he there, he turn back around, he's not there? I said, what the fuck?
He was just waiting like...
Oh, my God. Not the Undertaker.
Then while she's laying there, she hears me coming through the room with this shit.
My dumb ass,
He's methodical. Whatever. How you say it?
Diabolical. That's diabolical. What
methodical. Yes, you're right. Like, I can't even repeat the word. I'm stuck looking.
Bro, I get to her and I just stop. I don't make no noise.
You about just to walk stop. A dog?
Nigga, she's like, huh? What is that? What is that? Bro, when I tell you I looked at her box, the shit was leaking, my nigga. Leaking. I'm like, yo, keep in mind, I've never done this before. I've just like seriously connected to the idea of physical and mental stimulation right now. It's just like some other shit that I've just been on. I don't know why. I don't know what the fuck is wrong with me. But get in her head, bro.
I was waiting for the tip. All
right, yeah. I'm about to be like,
I thought the chains were the tip. I was like, are these also on the link you gave earlier?
Nah, I'm like, you gotta afford this tip.
The idea is getting her head, and that comes from earlier in the day. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That comes from the lead up, the walk into the crib. You guys actually mentioned it. The candles, all that shit. Yeah. It's all about setting the setting, and even with the things you do, the things you say, the mood that you place, it's all about getting in the person's fucking head. And I'm telling you right now, the nut that they get, bro. I ain't seen her nut like that in years.
It's
been a long time since I seen her nut the way she nutted that night. It's been a long fucking time.
She had to recalibrate that thing.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, make sure that you're actually putting in the fucking effort. If you really want to be that nigga, put in the fucking effort. You know what I'm saying? And save your dick for later.
Yo, I think that's the tip. Save your dick for later.
It might be the title.
That's a good tip. Might be the title of the episode. Yo, can we make that? Save your dick for later. Yeah. That's fire. All right, y'all. You're officially.
Sorry, y'all. Save your dick. Tuck away that dick. Put that shit away for later. Hey, you me, can come hey, back to it.
Let me get the dick to go. Yo, it's been a phenomenal episode, man. We've had our ups and downs, seriousness and bullshits, the hards and the softs. I'm King Loon the First. I'm here with
Jay Brooklyn Poppy.
And he's here with
Mel, a.k.a. Legendary Shit.
And we are all here with
the Chain Tahoe Toothbrushes.
Chain Gang.
The Chain Gang, nigga.
This is the Hardest Off Show. Why do you have two brushes?
It's again? I use a hard.
But you don't use them at the sink. All right, y'all. Just hit don't tell me it.
When you say freaky, what's freaky? What you mean by freaky? All right, if I do this, you're not going to tell your friends, right?